It's time for round two. NC State, Texas A&M set to face off for the second night in a row. Chris Lehman, Nick Prozzi with you here on PackTV. And Nick, it was a heck of a game last night. NC State all over the Aggies for most of that game, but couldn't put anything in the back of the net despite having 29 shots through two periods. And then everything opened up in the third. Outscoring the Aggies 5-1, NC State came away with a 5-3 win, a big one, and it sets up for a really good game tonight.
Yeah, and I think the big story going into this night is the chippiness going on. We saw a lot of it last night. Nick Shook was involved in a lot of it, Drew Bressingham as well. And on Texas A&M side, we saw Robbie Sowers get a little physical as well as Jacob Norwood. So I think tonight is going to be about keeping your composure and try to limit the penalties despite the chippiness.
Yeah, I think NC State certainly has the momentum going in. A huge third period last night. Zach Herman had a couple of goals. Holden Kaufman got things going on the power play. Special teams was really important, particularly in that third period. NC State picked up a power play goal and a shorthanded goal.
Yeah, and especially that penalty kill, the five-minute major that Cade McConaughey took last night. They had a shorthanded goal. They gave up a power play goal. So, in theory, they didn't lose any part of the lead or the deficit they had. It was still a net of zero. So that's something to take away as well, only allowing one goal on the five-minute major and a crucial part of that game, and then still coming out and winning it. Really shows how great this penalty kill team is.
Yeah, it's going to be a great one tonight, and going to have a change in net. No surprise on the NC State side that there will be a change in net, but certainly no lack of confidence in the man that will be between the pipes and Addison Lawrence.
Yeah, Lawrence, of course, a very seasoned veteran going into this one, and hopefully tonight he'll see some more shots and get kind of in a rhythm, which Toyer kind of didn't get in a rhythm early on, which is the reason why A&M had the two quick goals in that first period. So coming into tonight, I think Lawrence has to realize, hey, my defense is going to play really good, and if we play like we did the first period, I've got to be on my toes. I got to play my best game no matter what when they come down the ice and be prepared, because I'm not going to be able to get in a rhythm.
Yeah, NC State, I think, is certainly going to be looking to keep that in this game tonight, keep that same kind of flow to the game. One thing they did really, really well was work well at the blue lines, particularly their offensive blue line. They made it difficult for the Aggies to get into neutral ice.
Yeah, that forecheck NC State had last night was just really pivotal. It also kind of goes into the scheming for Texas A&M. They had a lot of bodies out in front of the net, so those rebounds, those shots, they're not really able to get to them. And then when they tried to break out, they weren't really able to get out of their own zone because NC State's forecheck was right there, forcing a turnover and getting a quick shot off of it.
Yeah, so NC State and Texas A&M finishing up warm-ups. We got a little over 10 minutes until puck drop. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we'll talk a little bit more specifics about last night's game and how NC State was able to make that comeback, and then how that can translate into a win here tonight. NC State and Texas A&M getting ready for round two.
Welcome to Moe's!
At Moe's, we've always been inviting, but we have a bigger story to tell. A place that welcomes you to be you. Fresh, high-quality ingredients. We got that. Go ahead, do your thing. Come on, let's get weird. We don't judge. Moe's wants you to come in with your crew and their appetites. Dine in, pick up, or order on the Moe Rewards app. Either way, don't just stroll in. Roll all in to Moe's Southwest Grill.
Locally owned and operated by an NC State graduate, the Red and White Shop is your source for all things NC State. Just off campus in the Ridgewood Shopping Center at 3526 Wade Avenue, the Red and White Shop has everything the NC State fan needs. Sporting goods and memorabilia, your favorite NC State team apparel, tailgating essentials, ice pack gear. A proud sponsor of the NC State hockey team, a percentage of all ice pack sales go back to the team. Stop by today or visit us online. The Red and White Shop.
From the top of DH Hill Library,
Don Diablo.
Oh yeah, this is actually like in my studio. With
WKNC HD3 Raleigh.
Hey, what's up and what's going on, folks? This is Kid Kinetic, your boy up here at the top of the hour. And guess what I got? A treat that's too sweet to beat.
This is Wolf Bites Radio.
Oh, that's really sweet.
NC State.
Oh, stupid controller froze again.
Spending less money,
I was wondering
so
if you guys wanted me. OMG, it's McGruff!
Yes, I am.
He's not my Uncle McGruff, the crime dog! He's a fake!
Oh! I am McGruff, the crime dog. He is the fake. And so is that controller you're holding. It's gonna break. Let's take a bite out of crime together.
Who says you're not the fake?
Dude, you're literally missing
it. You are smart, kids. You're smart. Buy smart.
Chris Lehman and Nick Prozzi back with you here at Invisalign Arena as NC State gets set to take on Texas A&M for a second straight night. And as we mentioned in our first segment, it was a very exciting game, a great comeback for NC State. But we want to delve a little bit more into how that game kind of all panned out. You mentioned the first couple periods, tough ones for Isaac Toyer, mostly just because he didn't see a high volume of shots. And as a result, as you mentioned, it's kind of hard to get into a flow of the game when that's the case. But NC State is something we talked about being a problem for them last weekend, and maybe not necessarily a problem for them, but just something that wasn't going their way was the puck luck. And of course, a game is not all about puck luck, but you need some bounces to go your way. And that was a big thing last night, was just eventually getting the bounces.
Yeah, and Toyer played a really good second and third period, only gave up that power play goal in the third on the five-minute major penalty. So props to Isaac Toyer staying in there the rest of the game despite having those issues early on with the rhythm. But going back to that puck luck, it seemed like NC State had none of it for the first two periods, but the third period came around. They had a puck luck chance right in front of the net that allowed one of the goals for Zach Herman last night, and then one of the floater shots that we saw later on, bit of puck luck there. So the tide kind of turned there for NC State as well as the offense. They were able to put up five goals last night in just the third period, which is something they struggled with before.
And being opportunistic is another thing that comes to mind when you talk about that, particularly the two goals that Zach Herman scored. One of them shorthanded, he gets that bounce, a hard clearance on the penalty kill, comes off the boards out to the center for a breakaway. He takes the opportunity, he finishes. Another one, deep in the zone, NC State, Texas A&M tied late in the game. It squirts loose near the high slot. Herman finds it, fires it at the net, and finishes. So NC State was very opportunistic in that third period, and I think that's certainly something that you have to keep an eye on, because something you could say about Texas A&M last night as well. Two goals on three shots in the first period. If you extrapolate that out to the second, two goals on five shots, still pretty good shooting numbers as a team, at least in terms of the shooting percentage. But both teams have been able to be opportunistic.
Yeah, and I think coming into tonight, Texas A&M has to say, hey, we played a really good first two periods last night. We had a star goalie in Circus in net last night. But going into tonight, we've got to play a little better defensively, and we've got to limit the shot totals. NC State was just blowing up the shot totals, and it's a bit of a problem this year for A&M. They've kind of allowed a lot of shots, and that kind of goes with their defensive scheming. But something they did really well last night was blocking those shots, and the reason why it gave NC State trouble is putting the puck in the back of the net early on was those block shots. But going into tonight, I think Texas A&M has to say, hey, we had two goals when we were getting outplayed last night. It can certainly happen again tonight. Let's look at that and let's build off that.
Yeah, and another thing that comes to mind, you know, is listening back to my conversation with head coach Tim Healy of the Ice Pack after last night's game, and something that's really kind of been a theme throughout the course of the season that we've seen in a lot of the games, or in some cases maybe a little bit of a lack of it, the Kentucky game. NC State just wasn't quite able to continue to press in a game where they had a tough opponent pushing back. Then against Liberty's Division II team, they were able to push back and win. They did the same thing against North Carolina. So resiliency and mental toughness, in particular, we're talking about Isaac Toyer, that was something that head coach Tim Healy mentioned, was that mental toughness to be able to stay in the game, stay at the top of your game as best of your ability when things aren't going your way.
Yeah, and I think one of the biggest stories this year for NC State is they haven't played a full 60 minutes of hockey sometimes, and it's a big reason why they've lost some key games, lost a lot of close games this year, and it kind of goes back to last year too. They lost a lot of 1-2 goal games that they were in the entire time until the shorty was hit at the end of the game. So going into the past couple of games they faced, the past week, and they were in it, they weren't able to finish it. But last night, that resiliency here at home, like we saw 2 weeks ago against UNC, being able to come back and win and kind of make a statement as well is something key, and that should be a big momentum going into tonight.
Yeah, we've done a lot of talking about these two teams here in this pregame. We're going to step aside for a moment. When we come back, we'll put a bow on it, give you our keys to the game, and get you set for puck drop between NC State and Texas A&M.
From the top of D.H. Hill Library.
Don Diablo.
Oh, yeah, this is actually, like, in my studio. With
WKNC HD3 Raleigh.
Hey, what's up and what's going on, folks? This is Kid Kinetic, your boy, up here at the top of the hour. And guess what I got? A treat that's too sweet to beat.
This is Wolf Bites Radio.
Aw, that's really sweet.
N.C. State.
Locally owned and operated by an NC State graduate, the Red and White Shop is your source for all things NC State. Just off campus in the Ridgewood Shopping Center at 3526 Wade Avenue, the Red and White Shop has everything the NC State fan needs. Sporting goods and memorabilia, your favorite NC State team apparel, tailgating essentials, ice pack gear. A proud sponsor of the NC State hockey team, a percentage of all ice pack sales go back to the team. Stop by today or visit us online. The Red and White Shop.
It's time to talk about men's mental health.
80% of suicides are done by men.
Men are 3 times less likely to ask for help if they are struggling.
One man every minute
commits suicide.
Men are more likely to suffer from substance abuse disorders.
Alcohol kills 6 times more men than women.
Men are 3 times less likely to ask for help if they are struggling.
We've never needed each other more
than we do right now.
It's okay to not be okay.
It's okay to talk about how you feel.
Being silent doesn't mean you are being strong.
This is a movement for men's health.
The silence needs to be broken.
Men need support too.
The stigma.
The stigma.
The stigma.
The stigma.
The stigma.
The stigma.
The stigma ends here.
The stigma ends here.
We are minutes away from puck drop between NC State and Texas A&M. Chris Lehman, Nick Prosby back with you. Just to wrap things up here on the pregame, Nick, we'll start with you. A couple of key points for NC State and Texas A&M after the history you see from last night.
The key number one tonight is limit the penalties. There weren't as many penalties as you would have thought there would have been last night, but we saw the chippiness pick up. We saw a major penalty last night. I think the key tonight is keeping your composure cool and not committing a lot of penalties despite the physicality we're going to expect tonight.
Yeah, for me, if it's NC State, I think, and this is really going to be what I think for both of these teams, both teams are going to want to play more like they did in the third period. If you're Texas A&M, you like that you had 2 goals on 5 shots, but I think you like it more that you had 15 shots in the third period after just 5 in the first 2. And, of course, if you're NC State, you kept doing the same thing, and you finally found the back of the net in the third. So I think for both teams, if they can play more like the third period, not only is it going to, or at least in theory for both of them, they're going to get a better result, but it's going to be a lot more fun contest for us to watch here. Well, the two teams just about set to get on the ice. Get the lineups announced and the national anthem. So we'll step aside one more time. When we come back, it'll be time for Puck Drop. NC State, Texas A&M, next.
Locally owned and operated by an NC State graduate, the Red and White Shop is your source for all things NC State. Just off campus in the Ridgewood Shopping Center at 3526 Wade Avenue, the Red and White Shop has everything the NC State fan needs. Sporting goods and memorabilia, your favorite NC State team apparel, tailgating essentials, ice pack gear. A proud sponsor of the NC State hockey team, a percentage of all ice pack sales go back to the team. Stop by today or visit us online. The Red and White Shop.
Welcome to
Moe's! At Moe's, we've always been inviting, but we have a bigger story to tell. A place that welcomes you to be you. Fresh, high-quality ingredients. We got that. Go ahead, do your thing. Come on, let's get weird. We don't judge. Moe's wants you to come in with your crew and their appetites. Dine in, pick up, or order on the Moe Rewards app. Either way, don't just stroll in. Roll all in to Moe's Southwest Grill.
Hey there, doing some yard work? Installing a new fence, flowers, or shrubs? Stop! Don't dig just yet! You have buried gas, electric, and even internet lines down there. Before you pick up a shovel, pick up a phone or go online and contact 811. 811 is a free service. Yes, free! 811 is the first step to having those buried utilities marked. 811 keeps you safe, protects the lines, and it's the law. This safety message brought to you by North Carolina 811.
When you look at me.
Welcome to Invisalign Arena here in Mooresville, North Carolina. Chris Lehman and Nick Prosby with you on PackTV. As they announce the starting lineups here, we'll give them to you as well. On the A&M side, really both teams switching some things up on the offensive side for A&M. They're going to go with Mason Burdett, Zach Colson, and Robbie Sowers, who scored both of the goals last night, or the first two goals, I should say, for A&M on the front end. And on the back end, it'll be Evan McQuaig and A.J. Cosman. So they'll shake up the starting lineups a little bit, but they will keep the same netminder in Jake Circus. On the NC State side, they're going to start the line of Zach Herman, flanked by Garrett Arini and Aiden Brenner. They'll go with Ricky Frosch and Cade Cox on the defensive side, and in net tonight will be the sophomore Addison Lawrence. So seeing changes on both sides in terms of the starting lineup, and of course with the way that you change lines in hockey, Nick, it's not quite as significant.
No, it's not, but sometimes it could give you a spark to a certain line. It could give you a spark deeper in a line, like a third or fourth line.
All right, well, we're ready for the national anthem, so we'll throw it down to the ice. Nothing left but to drop the puck here at Invisalign Arena as we get set for Texas A&M and NC State. Part two, as you mentioned, a bit of a change, at least in starting lineups. There are a few changes for NC State lineup-wise tonight. We'll note those for you now. Logan Todd will slot in on the fourth line with Thomas McEnany and Scott Daniel as he replaces Cam Lohr, who is in the lineup tonight. Couple of defensive changes on the bottom pairing. Jack Strong will pair up with Jackson Cowan, and the seventh defenseman tonight will be Alex James, as Cade McConaughey will get the rest tonight along with Jagielski. Pardon me. But NC State moving right to left in this first period. They'll wear those black Frozen Finley jerseys from last year with the white script and red trim. White jerseys with the pants and the white socks for A&M. And they'll win the opening draw. Misplayed at the defense, though. And it will be NC State pouncing on it, going on the attack. Arini leaves it at the hashes for Herman. He'll send it behind the net. Nobody there for NC State, but the clearance held in at the blue line. Frosch threw it across, looking for the stick of Herman, who couldn't quite direct it on goal. Sweeping it through the slot is Herman. Can't connect with Brenner. NC State maintains control, though. Brenner slides it behind the net, looking for Herman. Aiden Brenner coming over to help out, but it's A&M looking to clear. A pinching Cade Cox holds the zone for the moment, but it squirts loose to Sowers. He'll take it with speed down that far wing. Chips and chases. Has some help there from Burdett as well, as the puck stuck behind the NC State net at the moment. Burdett and Frosch battling for it. Burdett wins that battle. Trouble with the centering pass. Big save and a rebound denied as well by Addison Lawrence. The second try coming from Marshall Rushing. But a couple of good tries there. Now Lawrence, had a bit of a bouncer there in from center ice, holds on to that as well. And Nick, couple of testers there early for Lawrence.
Yeah, both teams are playing very fast, and a really big save of the left pad by Addison Lawrence off of the rebound. Both goalies getting a little bit tested. Lawrence getting more tested early on. First minute, we played very fast, I think, and that might be the big story going into tonight.
Govea and Rushing on the draw. It looks like Rushing wins it backwards for A&M, but NC State is able to clear the zone. Misplay there from Norwood leaves the puck sitting there at the blue line, picked up by the Aggies, and Christian Spearman shelves it behind, finds a man in front, they score. Quick centering pass to Jacob Smith, and 1:14 into this one, it's Aggies 1, NC State nothing.
On the board first again in the first period are the Aggies, and it's really just a great backwards pass right here. And Jacob Smith fills in the slot and just able to hammer it home. Really good pass by Marshall Rushing, who we thought was going to be a key factor yesterday. He kind of didn't get that, wasn't that key factor. But tonight he starts the game off with an assist. In the first minute, 14 seconds, 1-0 Aggies, who are off to another hot start. The question will be tonight, will they keep it going through all three periods?
NC State in possession. Cowan goes D to D on the near side. Sent forward by Alex James. Gets tangled up at the A&M blue line. Robinson comes away with it, looking for Emery Oliver at the blue line. They can't connect. This is off his skate. Now Ethan Chen carries it out. He'll play catch with Matthew Perry. Puck tipped over to the near side, and it'll be stolen away by Chen. Cowan didn't see him coming from behind. Chance there in front. Perry's shot sticked aside by Addison Lawrence, shot from the blue line, blocked by Bressingham as he stepped in front of Matthew Filick. NC State still can't clear. Chen having trouble with a couple of ice pack defenders on him. And A&M has to reset as the puck comes out of the zone. That'll give Jackson Cowan time to move forward. He's got space down that far side. Carries it behind, out in front. One-timer from Oliver, blocked on the way in. That was another thing that A&M did really well last night, particularly in the first two periods, was getting in the way of NC State shots. Aggies looking to break out. Pass stolen away by Scott Daniel. He'll hand it off for Logan Todd, who carries it deep. Todd held up in the corner, looking backwards for Frosch, who holds the zone but takes a heavy hit in the process. He's right back on his feet, though. Puck stuck along the wall. Todd and McEnany there for NC State, but it's Cade Willis poking it loose for A&M. Held in by Daniel at the blue line, and now cleared all the way down by Texas A&M. It's through the skates of Cade Cox, which means no icing, and A&M will have time to get a change. Breakout pass stolen away by Burdett. He'll chip it deep. Frosch in there to defend. Lost an edge. Puck still behind the cage, and it's Burdett coming away with it. Back to the blue line. Walking with it, McQuaig throws one on goal off the skate of Ricky Frosch, and NC State will send it the length of the ice, and this is going to be icing. NC State wanted to get a change, but they're going to have some tired bodies, and Nick, this isn't exactly what NC State wanted out of the start of this game. They're not able to hold the zone the way they were last night.
No, and how about Texas A&M able to hold their zone offensively as well? How about the play Ethan Chen made, stealing that pass, getting a quick shot on goal? He had a really good game last night with the third goal for the Aggies, and he got beat up a lot last night. Took a lot of big hits. So seeing him out there make this sneaky good plays is something the Aggies really like to see.
Face off to the near side of Addison Lawrence. One back to Shook, throws it into traffic, and that one deflects over to the near wall once more. Popped up near the high slot. Quick shot from Sowers, fought away by Addison Lawrence. A&M keeps the pressure on as they hold the blue line. NC State goes with the bank pass intended for Herman. He's not able to track it down, and now the Aggies will send it the length of the ice. That was number 23, AJ Cosman, who ices the puck, and NC State will get the offensive zone draw.
Well, something that we didn't really bring up in the pregame is that when you play a team for the second straight night, you kind of pick up on their weaknesses and their strengths, and you're able to adjust to them. And right now, through the first almost four minutes, Texas A&M has done a really good job making those adjustments.
Well, and they'll win another faceoff. They've been fairly dominant early on in the faceoff circle. As a puck chipped up and out of play in the NC State bench, faceoff will be on top of the ice pack blue line. But the flow just isn't there yet for NC State. We'll see as things carry on, certainly still very early. But we really didn't see many points last night where Texas A&M controlled the game the way they have here in the first four. Pass up the middle for Herman. Labrisi's feed was deflected. And M sends it right back towards the NC State net. Labrisi trying to force one up the middle. That's denied by Spearman. Marshall rushing comes away with it. The Aggies on the attack. Another shot fired just wide by Jacob Smith, who scored the first one. This has been the productive line so far for A&M. And Smith, strong forecheck, knocks it loose. Play reverse to the other side, though, by Aiden Brenner. NC State still trying to find a breakout pass up the near side. Back into the middle for Thronson. He finds Herman, who directs it into the corner as NC State needs a change. Now Norwood carrying it forward. Shovels it past Cowan, who will chase it down behind the NC State net. Looking up the ice, he's got Kaufman. Head up, Kaufman looking for a pass. It's not there. Instead, he floats it in. Norwood knocks it down and sends it right back out. Kaufman again. This one, he gets past Norwood. It'll trickle right in on Circus, and with some pressure coming, he'll melt it down for another faceoff.
Well, in the pregame, we talked about the physicality that we should see from both teams and the chippiness, but so far through the first 5 minutes, we haven't seen much. We've seen a couple of hits be made, but after play extracurriculars haven't been there.
Right off the draw, a shot coming from Nick Shook, and it'll be held on to by Circus. They'll try it once again. Govea to take the faceoff up against Texas A&M's Matthew Perry. Perry wins it, and he wins it right to his goaltender. So another faceoff coming for NC State. 14:56 left in this first period. NC State down 1-0. As there is still some fans trickling in here on this Saturday night. Govea on the draw, looking to win it over to the wall. But nobody there in a black jersey able to corral it. A&M breaks it out. Picked up at the blue line by Ethan Chen. Looking back to the middle for Perry. Missed him. And it's into the near corner where NC State can turn it the other way. Here's Holden Kaufman going rink wide. Off the skates of Govea. Ooh, he was just barely onside. I think now actually they... Not 100% sure. I think they did eventually call it offsides. I think the official overruled the linesman. And I think that was the right call.
Yeah, it looked like one of the linesmen overruled it. And I was going to say, waved it off. I was a little confused because the puck had clearly not entered yet when NC State was in the zone.
Another faceoff win for Texas A&M. Kaufman with the forecheck at the blue line. Big hit from Govea as he plants Daniel Dufresne. NC State throwing the body around. Govea again with a hard hit on Matthew Perry this time. And now NC State just got to translate that into some shots on goal as they send it the length of the ice. Another icing call. But we've seen a lot of those tonight. And you know, you look at it, both of these teams played a tough one last night. A little bit of a late finish, obviously. A slightly earlier start tonight. But you wonder how much... You know, the fatigue plays in. They're only 6 minutes in, but it is back-to-back nights. It's not all too often that you see that. But both teams still kind of seem to be finding their way. NC State a little bit more, though, than Texas A&M.
NC State's delivering a lot more bigger hits, but both teams aren't taking exception to the hits that are being made.
Pass intercepted by Sowers, dropped it off. Nobody there, and NC State will take it back. Pass intended for Robinson, a little bit long. Tries to chase it down, but he's beat to it there by Kosman, who clears the zone for the Aggies. Lifted across to the far wall by Frosch, sent in by Robinson. Clearance now knocked down by Bresingham. Sends it to the middle, rebound loose in front. They score! Amory Oliver with his second of the weekend, and NC State has tied it up at one.
This play never happens if Ricky Frosch doesn't bat down the puck at center ice. Otherwise, it's going to go all the way down for an icing. And then Drew Bressingham comes on in, takes a shot from the right circle. It gets a nice rebound, and Emory Oliver snipes it in up close, right past Jake Circus. And we're tied at one. So NC State able to get a first period goal tonight to answer back.
So we're back even. Not quite 7 minutes into this contest, Cade Cox looking up the far side. Finds his target, the goal scorer, Oliver, looking across. Brenner squares it up, back to the middle, one-time shot. Big save there, and Circus will hold on. A little bit of a different line there, as it was actually Emery Oliver with Drew Bresingham and Aiden Brenner.
Yeah, Zach Robinson was not out there. He's usually on that second line with Bresingham and Oliver, and you don't really see that coming off of a faceoff from a goal where you can make those line changes. So a little interesting there, especially early in the game.
NC State wins the faceoff. Todd with the turnaround shot wide. A&M able to put out in the neutral ice. Bouncing puck gets past Cade Cox. He's going to get tied up and knocked down as he went one-on-one there with Nicholas Leone. A&M able to hold the zone, battling in that near corner for the moment. Puck squirts loose. It's McEnany coming away with it. His pass to the middle, shut down by Leone and sent right back down the ice. NC State will regroup. Cox at his own blue line. Pass disrupted. He'll get it right back. Threads the needle to McEnany up the ice. Looking to the middle for Todd. That pass intercepted, and Kale Morrow unable to clear after taking it away. He'll drop it off for Norwood. Puck hops his stick, having a little bit of trouble with it down there behind the goal, and it's taken away by McEnany. Out in front, shot, they score, another one. This time it's Scott Daniel, NC State with a pair in just over a minute, and they've got the 2-1 lead.
Well, to be able to get that puck from Jacob Norwood, I mean, to set up that goal was really Thomas McEnany, the fourth line for NC State, able to get a goal as well to go up 2-1. What a play by McEnany against the top defenseman and Jacob Norwood for A&M. That is a very impressive play, especially from a freshman to get the freshman to freshman, excuse me, McEnany the junior, to get the freshman a goal right in front. And it's 2-1 pack.
Herman to take the faceoff at center ice. One over to the near side. Immediately on it is Aiden Brenner. He'll hold up along the half wall. Pass in the middle, deflected into the corner. It'll be tracked down by Herman. Up to Thronson at the blue line. Throws it at the net, steered away by Duke Circus. NC State, all the momentum now. Shots favoring the pack. 5-4 now. It was 4-1 at one point. Pass to the middle. Oh, good tie up there. Right in front, Daniel Dufresne lifted the stick of Garrett Arini and likely prevented another goal. Arini. Good back check on Dufresne now and knocks the puck loose, and NC State will take control.
Really good My bad there, Chris. Really good hustle from Garrett Arini getting back on the back check, getting a good stick lift to get that puck back for the pack.
Herman deflects it deep, and looks like the linesman didn't see it. Herman disagrees, but it will be an icing call on NC State here, and the puck comes all the way back down.
Arini, who just had that really quick magic check with that great hustle, is going to have to stay out there for another faceoff. He's going to want a quick win and a quick change.
McEnany on the draw, but is Zach Colson winning it for A&M? Aggie's able to hold the line as Cosman chips it back down the near wall. Labrizzi with pressure, getting some help now from Brenner. And in comes Dufresne to contribute to it as well, as a quick shot coming from the point will be gloved and held by Lawrence. Not a bad idea there from Cosman to try and catch the ice pack netminder off guard.
No, and it caused Addison Lawrence kind of to catch that like a foul ball almost, with the glove horizontal up high. So a quick shot from the point sometimes it gets them off guard.
Cosman wins another faceoff, and the shot this time doesn't get through for Cosman. Instead, it deflects to the middle where Nick Shook can take over. Drags around his man. Beautiful move. Looking to the middle. Nick Kaufman with a chance. Couldn't get the shot away. This time he does, and it's another goal. NC State with three straight, and it's now 3-1.
Well, the troubles last night, they're not here tonight. How about the effort from Nick Shook? The puck goes right back behind the net. He's able to get puck luck at center ice to get them set up.
And a way to turn things around. They really had the hold of this game. They were dictating play, spent a lot of time in the offensive end. And ever since NC State scored that first goal, they just haven't looked back. Now we get a whistle on the touch-up, and I think we're going to get our first penalty of the game. I think it's going to go against NC State here. Joey Govea sent to the box for interference.
And You mentioned it last night. NC State did not have bodies in front, but now they're getting these quick chances on the other end where there's not many bodies for either team, so they're able to get a quick pass, have someone right in front of the net, not defended or guarded by, and allows for that quick shot right in front, which is something they didn't really do the first two periods last night. They made those adjustments, and that's why they have 8 goals in their last 30 minutes, going back to yesterday.
Well, this isn't necessarily a power play that's going to determine the game, but if you're NC State, having scored the last 3, you'd really like to kill this off and keep the momentum. A&M wins the draw. They'll set up the power play from the top of the umbrella. The shot from Norwood deflected high and over the net. A&M keeps the pressure on. Norwood again. He'll walk with it down to the top of the near circle, looking to the middle. Pass fanned on. It was a one-time attempt there from Smith. We have another arm up and another penalty on NC State coming. A&M still on the attack. Shot from Norwood blocked. Rebound in front. Lawrence makes the save. It's still bouncing around. Loose in the crease, and Lawrence is going to cover it up. But NC State's going to have a long 5-on-3 to kill off here. A minute and 22 of it to be exact. But we'll get the call here in a moment.
I don't know if the refs called that earlier or not. I couldn't really hear the whistle, but if they did, that saved NC State right there because of the late penalty. A&M probably didn't want the play to stop like that. And going to the box is going to be Cade Cox. It's going to be because of a cross check.
NC State, as mentioned, with a minute and 22 seconds of 5-on-3 here to kill.
He's asking for the explanation because that came from the back judge. He's all the way at neutral ice, and he's explaining the play that happened. So a quick 5-on-3 here for the Aggies.
NC State has Labrizzi, Brenner, and Thronson on the ice for the penalty kill. Marshall Rushing will take the faceoff against Brenner, who wins it back into the corner. And we cleared off the glass, but not out. Matthew Perry on the blue line leaves it for Norwood. Back it down that far side. Now to Rushing. His slant pass blocked. A&M able to maintain control. It's Rushing again. Walking the goal line. Looking over to Jacob Smith. He'll send it to the wall where they can reset with Zach Colson. Again, it's Rushing. Over to Norwood. He'll walk it in. Throws it wide from the far faceoff dot. This one skitters all the way out. Aiden Brenner in a foot race here with Rushing. A&M wins that battle. They'll move it back the other way. Colson with some speed into the zone. He'll curl behind the net. Looks back up top where he's got Norwood. 40 seconds of 5-on-3 left. Pass to the middle. Deflected, and a pad save made by Lawrence. Good agile movement there from the netminder. A&M still with the pressure. Norwood, one-timer, save made by Lawrence. He fights it into the corner, and a pass gets out of the zone just past Norwood. Brenner, not enough energy. He's going to head off for a change. 20 seconds of 5-on-3 left. Just a little under a minute left on the five on, or the penalty to Cade Cox, but it may stay 5-on-3 here.
Yep,
but NC State just can't avoid the penalty box right now. This time it's Labrizzi.
There's a big collision that 3 bodies go down. Labrizzi was at the bottom of it, the 2 A&M players will call in a second. Or not, the referees will not show us what it was.
I believe I saw a hooking signal there. So a hooking penalty on Labrizzi, and it'll stay 5-on-3 on NC State here. I believe Gouveia can't leave the box until the next stoppage. As his penalty winding down, still 40 seconds of 5-on-3. Now the penalty starts as well. That's the other thing to keep in mind. When there's that extra penalty, it doesn't start till the end of Gouveia's. So we still have a minute 50 left on the penalty to Labrizzi. About 25 seconds of 5-on-3 still for Texas A&M. They've had a lot of time on 5-on-3. In fact, it'll be, I think, exactly 2 minutes by the end of it. Into the near corner. Aggie still trying to work it out in front. Ethan Chen over to the far dot. He's got Sowers playing catch there with McQuaig. Sowers again, bottom of the circle, up to the top. McQuaig shot, deflected up and over. 5-on-3 finally over as Gouveia comes out of the penalty box. NC State continuing to try and kill this penalty. Pass down to the far post, missing the deflection. Sowers probably had an open net there as well. NC State looking to clear. Gouveia, the fresh body, clears at the length of the ice, and that will kill off more time. A minute left on the hooking penalty to To NC State's Cade NC State's Nick Labrizzi. Cade Cox is also still in the penalty box. He can't come out until the stoppage here or until the end of this penalty. Barini looking to clear. That's blocked by Jacob Smith. He'll look down low. And just not a lot of chances generated here by A&M. This one will be a chance as Lawrence covers up the rebound. Shot through traffic there from Smith. That's a tough one to see if you're the goaltender for the Ice Pack.
I think right now this penalty kill for the Ice Pack is really, really good, despite the fact that they've only been able to shoot it down the ice one time. The fact that they're able to take away the shooting lanes, you mentioned it, Chris, not a lot of opportunities for A&M. At the end of that 5-on-3, I felt like there wasn't a sense of urgency, saying, hey, we still got a couple extra seconds with just three defensive men in front of us. Let's take advantage of that, and I don't think they did.
Puck tied up along the far wall. Clearance from Bresingham is bodied down by Norwood. They'll keep the power play rolling. Norwood shot blocked by Bresingham. Now Arini gets a stick to the elevated pass, but A&M will keep it. Matthew Perry tees one up. Big blocker save from Lawrence. Down to 15 seconds left on the man advantage. NC State will break it out. Arini with 10 seconds left on the kill will take it himself. Trying to work around Norwood. Instead, button hooks into the far corner. Sends it behind, intended for Bresingham. Rushing steps in the way. Arini in on the forecheck. As you hear a sound effect that tells you NC State's back to 5-on-5. There's 6 minutes now and change left in this first period. It's been an eventful first period, to say the least. Shot from the point, swallowed up by the goaltender Lawrence after Evan McQuaid loaded one up. But quite the first period so far. Had all kinds of action. And if you're NC State, you don't like the fact that you took three penalties in the span of a minute and 45 seconds, but you do like the fact that you killed them all off.
Yeah, and I think when you go into the locker room at intermission, you're going to say it wasn't our cleanest period, but we're still up 3-1 right now. It's assuming the score will hold, obviously, the way this period's gone, who knows what will happen. But you go into the locker room, you're still up 3-1. And you got to be a little proud about that, but you know you can clean things up, like the penalties, the goal you allowed right away to start the game. There's still some room for improvement.
And that wins yet another faceoff. They have been dominant in the faceoff circle so far tonight. It's unofficial count, but they're somewhere in the realm of 67% on the faceoff percentage. NC State breaks it in. Shook sends it to the middle. Thronson didn't expect it to come, so he curled off. And A&M will break it back out. That's Colson forced into the wall. Here comes another penalty on NC State. Well, we talked about discipline. NC State, fourth penalty of the first period.
It's going to be Nick Shook right up against the boards, pushed from behind. They're going to conference about this for a second. I think it is just going to be a 2-minute. And once again, Shook was a big hit that picks up a penalty, something A&M took exception to last night. And just before that, Joey Govea laid a big hit. He got checked back, which knocked him down. But Govea's laid a couple of big hits tonight. He's been a bit of an enforcer, which you kind of don't see out of a playmaker like him. But back to the penalty kill goes NC State. They really only had a minute or two of 5-on-5, it seems like. And once again, they're going to be killing a penalty. That's going to be a massive point of emphasis Tim Healy's going to bring up in the locker room.
That'll be Marshall rushing. Against NC State's Emory Oliver. Oliver went into the corner. NC State can't clear them. A&M has done a really good job, particularly on the power play, of winning a draw or controlling it after the draw and getting a good possession. Big save from Lawrence, who swats away the rebound. And now A&M will break it back in. Marshall rushing, holding up along the hashes over on the far side. Pressure there from Cade Cox as it's sent behind for Matthew Perry. Cox knocks his man down and throws it the length of the ice. Good play there by the defenseman.
Very good job by Cade Cox, knocking him down, getting the puck, and immediately shooting it down. Not many opportunities other than that one A&M saw for the first 40 seconds of this power play.
Rushing will break it into the zone again, leaves it there for Smith. Again to Rushing, cross ice, shot, they score. This time A&M finds the back of the net, a snipe from Nicholas Leone, and it's a one-goal hockey game.
Seventh goal of the year with a man out of Huntington Beach, California. Just a really good pass by Marshall Rushing for his second assist of the night. Very nice celebration as well, if I may, Nicholas Leone. And just like that, you play with fire for so long, it's going to burn you. Four penalties was that fire, and NC State not able to kill off all four now, letting one go by to make this a 3-2 game. If you're A&M, 4.5 minutes left in this first period that saw a lot of action, going to get you some momentum building on. You know NC State's trying to get underneath your skin, but they keep picking up penalties, so you got to use that to your advantage.
Ooh, hit from behind there. NC State wanted a call and didn't get it as Garrett Arini was run straight through the numbers. He's going to give it back to McQuaig a little bit too as NC State moves forward. Brenner having trouble controlling the pass. A&M clears it from the defense. Cowan will gain the red line and throw it right off a linesman. And A&M can take it back. Now Colson has some space down the near right wing. Pressure there from Brenner, who'll cut to the middle. Looking for Burdett, threw it behind his teammate though. And a puck loose in that far corner. Cowan directs it behind his own net, stolen away. Burdett, a chance off the bar. Great chance there for A&M to tie it. And they're gonna keep the pressure on. Norwood shoves it towards the net. It'll be directed back behind. Norwood has it again. Dropped off now for Morrow. Across, and unable to get a shot away there was Burdett. NC State will clog it up in the near wall. Another NC State player going down. Herman is not gonna get back up either.
Two goals last night for Herman, a little slow to get up. Took a big hit in that pile, got shaken up, and Texas A&M, really the last couple, almost 7-10 minutes now, they've been able to keep constant offensive pressure. They're going to actually might be calling a penalty here. They did call a penalty here, actually. NC State's going to go on the power play.
That was the second play in a row there where it looked like an A&M player came in and got too much of the numbers. And so it'll be Burdett off. I didn't see the signal. It is a minor penalty. My guess would be boarding. Either way, again, it's a two-minute power play. NC State would look to answer as Nick Shook's shot off the draw is blocked, but NC State holds the zone. Bronson back to Shook. He'll fire again. He scores! I'm not sure if it hit Govea on the way through, but either way, 11 seconds into the power play, and NC State with the answer.
Well, just when A&M had all momentum, it just goes down the drain. They're able to work the point. NC State Shook from the top of it, and it's kind of hard to tell from this angle if it did hit the stick of Govea. I'm going to give that one to Nick Shook, and we'll see at intermission who scored that. I think it was Nick Shook, though, Chris.
Well, that's a big response there from NC State as well. You really struggle to stay out of the box. Eventually, it comes back to bite you, and you're only up by one, but you draw the penalty yourself and respond in just 11 seconds with the goal. So NC State, 4-2 lead, just 3 minutes left in this first period. We say just, it feels like this has been two periods. Labrisi carries it in for NC State off the center ice draw. He'll leave it in the near corner. Nobody there in a black jersey though. And the first one there is Texas A&M's Matthew Perry, but his pass behind the net, stolen away. Todd tried to throw it out in front. Skinner's all the way to the far side. Now Daniel at the blue line. Looking across, Todd fans on the shot on a bouncing puck. He'll get it back, sweeps it towards the goal. It's deflected back to Scott Daniel. His shot handled nicely by Circus. And now A&M throws it off the glass. It'll bounce over the stick of Thronson, who retreats into the neutral ice to get it back and send it deep. And I'm just looking for that breakout pass. NC State, that forecheck looking a little bit more like it did last night. Not many options there. Cosman threw it off the glass and down. NC State trying to catch A&M on a change. Daniel has speed, throws it out in front. Shot there from Strong, and a save made as Circus did a nice job getting over and squaring up to that shot.
Well, that power play gave NC State some momentum back. Now the ice has tilted a bit to be more in the NC State's offensive zone, which is something they need because they were on their heels defensively for a long bit. Referees are going to discuss something here. Not sure what they're talking about. Maybe a timing issue might be the reason. They did go over and talk to the timekeeper.
I think what it may have been, there's no real attendant in that visiting penalty box, and I think when Burdett came out, it was still a little bit loose, and the scoring table might have asked for that to be closed up. Ooh, a chance there for Bresingham. Puck was tied up in front. He spun one towards the goal and just wide. Good pressure here from NC State, down to a minute 40 left in the period. It'll be pinned to the wall. Robinson in to help out. Bresingham in there as well with Jack Strong. Now Emery Oliver has his shot blocked, gets it right back, carries it deep, throws it in front. And it's off the pad of Circus and out through the high slot where A&M can carry it now. Shot right into the breadbasket of Addison Lawrence from Daniel Dufresne. And NC State will have a defensive zone draw.
I like that shot from Daniel Dufresne there. You're entering the offensive zone all by yourself. You get it on net, and it forces a face-off. You're able to win it like it. Texas A&M has dominated today. It's going to allow for you to set up offensively with all five.
Off the draw. Shot deflected wide for the Aggies. They'll hold the zone, though. We've already had almost as many goals. We're just two goals shy of that total we had last night here in the first period. Plus a whole lot of penalties, mostly on the NC State side, but they've done a pretty good job handling the shorthanded scenarios. And, of course, scored on their only power play. Cox at the blue line. His shot hit a stick and goes up into the netting behind the goal. Offensive zone faceoff with 51 and a half left in the first.
Well, last 51 seconds, more than likely probably going to be your last line change here, and NC State's going to bring that third line with the Remy, Herman, and Aiden Brenner. So if you're the Pack, you want to win this faceoff and set up for the last 50 seconds, or now they're going to have to try to get a good forecheck.
A&M breaks it out. Three on three, moving forward on the rush. And Jacob Smith has it poked off his stick at the blue line. Arini taken down blindside, and this is an easy one for the officials to call, as I believe it's going to be Evan McQuaig to the penalty box. He didn't end up getting Arini in the head, but it was a bit of a blindside hit. Good sportsmanship there from McQuaig. Just a quick tap there to Arini, let him know no ill intentions. But penalties at least a little bit here evening out. NC State called for four in a row. All of them, no argument with any of them, I would say. But we're starting to see the scales tip back in NC State's favor. It'll be their second power play.
I think Arini was upset there, not only because it was blindside, but because he's taken a lot of hits tonight.
NC State controls. They'll have about 30 seconds of power play time before the end of the period. Herman, top of the circle, looking to the middle for Arini. That one's deflected and cleared out by A&M. Here comes Herman. He'll carry it behind the net, down to 8 seconds left. NC State looking for one final shot here. Herman, high slot, backhand pass, stolen away. Good defensive effort there by Marshall Rushing, who clears at the length of the ice to finish off the period. So quite a lot happening in that first period. A total of six penalties, four on NC State, two to Texas A&M, and a total of six goals. Couldn't have asked for much more action.
Yeah, and we talked pregame, we got to limit the penalties today because of the aggressive and chippiness. We haven't seen the extracurriculars after the play, but we've seen a lot of penalties. I think both teams going in the locker room are going to admit that they got to stop taking them. And I think for A&M, you've got to play a bit better defensively and finish those chances offensively.
Well, NC State off to a stronger start than they were last night. Four goals on 11 shots to take a two-goal advantage into the second 20 minutes. We'll be back on the first intermission right after this break.
From the top of D.H. Hill Library.
Don Diablo.
Oh, yeah, this is actually, like, in my studio.
WKNC HD3 Raleigh.
Hey, what's up and what's going on, folks? It's Kid Kinetic, your boy, up here at the top of the hour. And guess what I got? A treat that's too sweet to beat.
This is Wolf Bites Radio.
Aw, that's really sweet.
NC State.
Locally owned and operated by an NC State graduate, the Red and White Shop is your source for all things NC State. Just off campus in the Ridgewood Shopping Center at 3526 Wade Avenue, the Red and White Shop has everything the NC State fan needs. Sporting goods and memorabilia, your favorite NC State team apparel, tailgating essentials, ice pack gear. A proud sponsor of the NC State hockey team, a percentage of all ice pack sales go back to the team. Stop by today or visit us online. The Red and White Shop.
Hey there, doing some yard work, installing a new fence, flowers, or shrubs? Stop! Don't dig just yet! You have buried gas, electric, and even internet lines down there. Before you pick up a shovel, pick up a phone or go online and contact 811. 811 is a free service. Yes, free! 811 is the first step to having those buried utilities marked. 811 keeps you safe, protects the lines, and it's the law. This safety message brought to you by North Carolina 811.
Welcome to Mo!
At Mo's, we've always been inviting, but we have a bigger story to tell. A place that welcomes you to be you. Fresh, high-quality ingredients. We got that. Go ahead, do your thing. Come on, let's get weird. We don't judge. Mo's wants you to come in with your crew and their appetites. Dine in, pick up, or order on the Mo Rewards app. Either way, don't just stroll in. Roll all in to Mo's Southwest Grill.
I'm with 2018 lacrosse national champion Christian Gaudy for the FDA's Don't Get Burned Sunscreen Challenge.
Bring it, Daryl.
She's tough, but I won't get burned today. I'm using a broad spectrum sunscreen.
The FDA recommends broad spectrum sunscreens with an SPF of 15 or higher with other sun protection measures to reduce the risk of sunburn and skin cancer.
You smoked me, Kristen.
That's because I use sunscreen, so I wouldn't get burned by you and the sun.
Broad spectrum sunscreen. It's a winning play every time.
Quite the eventful period here at Invisalign Arena. NC State 4-2 lead over Texas A&M after 20 minutes. Chris Lehman, Nick Prozzi back with you at the first intermission. And Nick, as we talked about, a lot of things happened in that period that we kind of talked about. Mostly a lot of penalties, six total penalties. NC State spent a full minute, or 2 minutes, I should say, on a 5-on-3, killed it off. They did take one too many penalties and gave one up. But overall, from a penalty-killing standpoint, NC State did a pretty good job.
Yeah, you got to be happy from the penalty-killing standpoint, just like last night as well, able to kill off all but one. And going back to last week and able to kill off 14 of 15, really, really impressive, this penalty-killing unit for NC State. But going into the locker room, if you take a bunch of penalties again, they're averaging around 5 to 6 a game. You already got 4. You don't want to take as many more. It's not going to be helpful for your defense or your goaltender. Mm-hmm. And in a 4-2 game like this, in a kind of a wacky game that we've seen where A&M struck first, you don't really know what to expect, and you don't want a penalty to be the reason why you go down.
Yeah, and one thing that wasn't short, along with the penalties, what wasn't short was the goals. 6 goals as well. NC State picked up 4. We talked about how it was really a grind for them last weekend in the first two periods. Last night, 9 goals in the last two periods of hockey, not too shabby.
No, not at all, and especially for a team that was struggling going back to last week and getting the puck in the net, coming out and getting 4 more in the first period tonight after the struggles they had the first two periods last night is really impressive, especially since they haven't had the offensive zone time like they did last night. A&M fought back a bit tonight, and at one point it seemed like A&M was doing a lot better job of dominating the offensive end. So going into this next period, I think NC State will try to find out how they did so well last night and try to implement that tonight.
Well, speaking of goal scorers, we have the man who scored the first one of the night, Emery Oliver, waiting to join us on the other side. We'll be right back.
Locally owned and operated by an NC State graduate, the Red and White Shop is your source for all things NC State. Just off campus in the Ridgewood Shopping Center at 3526 Wade Avenue, the Red and White Shop has everything the NC State fan needs. Sporting goods and memorabilia, your favorite NC State team apparel, tailgating essentials, ice pack gear. A proud sponsor of the NC State hockey team, a percentage of all ice pack sales go back to the team. Stop by today or visit us online. The Red and White Shop.
Welcome to Mo!
At Moe's, we've always been inviting, but we have a bigger story to tell. A place that welcomes you to be you. Fresh, high-quality ingredients. We got that. Go ahead, do your thing. Come on, let's get weird. We don't judge. Moe's wants you to come in with your crew and their appetites. Dine in, pick up, or order on the Moe Rewards app. Either way, don't just stroll in. Roll all in to Moe's Southwest Grill.
It's time to talk about men's mental health.
80% of suicides are done by men.
Men are 3 times less likely to ask for help if they are struggling.
One man every minute
commits suicide.
Men are more likely to suffer from substance abuse disorders.
Alcohol kills 6 times more men than women.
Men are 3 times less likely to ask for help if they are struggling.
We've never needed each other more
than we do right now.
It's okay to not be okay.
It's okay to talk about how you feel.
Being silent doesn't mean you are being strong.
This is a movement for men's health.
The silence needs to be broken.
Men need support too.
The stigma ends here.
The stigma ends here.
Back here in Invisalign Arena with the man that had a goal last night, and he had the opening goal tonight, Emery Oliver. Now, Emery, going to that first goal, it was very similar to last night. Take me through getting into that first goal and how big it was to tie the game.
So we had I don't remember if it was Yarber Bresch, but we're going in, threw a shot on net, and I was just crashing back door. Lucky enough, the rebound came to me, got shot off. Didn't realize it went in, but boys came to Sally, so it was good.
Yeah, Bressingham was able to get that puck on the right side, and you were right there for the rebound to pick it up. But going back to last night, you guys had a lot of struggles early on, able to score 5 in the third period last night, all the goals you guys scored. You got 4 already this period. What kind of adjustments were made since you are playing the same team again to hit an explosive offensive showcase tonight?
I think it's just bringing in the same mentality that we brought in from the third period. After the third period, we opened up, we knew what we could do. And so we're just bringing that same thing in today, and it's working out so well.
Saw a lot of events this past period, hits wise, penalty wise, and goals. What are some things you guys are going to try to clean up going into this third?
Obviously we got to clean up the penalties. Can't be staying in the box all the time. I think that's the main thing. Once you get to 5-on-5, I think we'll dominate.
All right. Well, that was your goal scorer first of the night. Had one last night, Emery Oliver. We'll be back after this from Invisalign Arena.
Hey there, doing some yard work? Installing a new fence, flowers, or shrubs? Stop! Don't dig just yet! You have buried gas, electric, and even internet lines down there. Before you pick up a shovel, pick up a phone or go online and contact 811. 811 is a free service. Yes, free! 811 is the first step to having those buried utilities marked. 811 keeps you safe, protects the lines, and it's the law. This safety message brought to you by North Carolina 811.
At Moe's, we've always been inviting, but we have a bigger story to tell. A place that welcomes you to be you. Fresh, high-quality ingredients. We got that. Go ahead, do your thing. Come on, let's get weird. We don't judge. Moe's wants you to come in with your crew and their appetites. Dine in, pick up, or order on the Moe Rewards app. Either way, don't just stroll in. Roll all in to Moe's Southwest Grill.
Locally owned and operated by an NC State graduate, the Red and White Shop is your source for all things NC State. Just off campus in the Ridgewood Shopping Center at 3526 Wade Avenue, the Red and White Shop has everything the NC State fan needs. Sporting goods and memorabilia, your favorite NC State team apparel, tailgating essentials, ice pack gear. A proud sponsor of the NC State hockey team, a percentage of all ice pack sales go back to the team. Stop by today or visit us online. The Red and White Shop.
It's hard to always know what's going on with your kids. The Talk They Hear You mobile app and Screen for Success tool can help. The mobile app shows you how to turn everyday situations into opportunities to talk with your kids about alcohol and other drugs. Screen for Success helps you find out if your child needs more support by asking about their health, wellness, and well-being. Keep your kids safe and healthy. Download the free Talk They Hear You mobile app and start using Screen for Success today.
Chris Lehman and Nick Prozzi back with you here on PackTV at the first intermission. NC State with a 4-2 lead over Texas A&M. So, Nick, good start for NC State. The big thing I think is good to see is the goal scoring is back for this team. Another big period of goals.
Yeah, that last period from last night, the five goals, that's really been a big motivator into this offense. It kind of got things clicking. And going into this this game tonight, it had to be a fast start. They didn't get the first one, but scoring four of the last five is something you got to be really proud about offensively.
Well, and you know, we're only through 20 minutes, so maybe using the word resilience isn't necessarily the right thing here, but being able to bounce back like they did last night, like they did against North Carolina, like they did against Liberty, as we've seen, seeing them bounce back and pick up some goals, then deal with all the penalties, give up a goal, and then get another one back. The bounce back ability has been good as well.
Yeah, it really has been. I mean, you got a penalty kill as good as the Ice Packs. It's really beneficial to have, even with all the penalties they take. But at one point or another, it's going to start biting them back. They're not going to be able to kill as many off. And this is a very potent Texas A&M power play team. They have two in these two games now on the power play. So going into the second period, NC State has to clean it up, or I think A&M is going to start getting things to click, and we're going to see a lot more power play goals from the Aggies.
Well, speaking of power plays, NC State will have a power play to start the second period, so we'll see how they're able to do with that. They did a great job on the power play in the first, though, scoring on their first and only opportunity at this point. Of course, still about a minute 27 left on the opportunity going into the second period, so that'll certainly be important when it comes to starting the period right. And when it comes to starting the period right, we're going to talk about that on the other side as we get set for the second period.
Hey there, doing some yard work? Installing a new fence, flowers, or shrubs? Stop! Don't dig just yet! You have buried gas, electric, and even internet lines down there. Before you pick up a shovel, pick up a phone, or go online and contact 811. 811 is a free service. Yes, free! 811 is the first step to having those buried utilities marked. 811 keeps you safe, protects the lines, and it's the law. This safety message brought to you by North Carolina 811.
At Moe's, we've always been inviting, but we have a bigger story to tell. A place that welcomes you to be you. Fresh, high-quality ingredients. We got that. Go ahead, do your thing. Come on, let's get weird. We don't judge. Moe's wants you to come in with your crew and their appetites. Dine in, pick up, or order on the Moe Rewards app. Either way, don't just stroll in. Roll all in to Moe's Southwest Grill.
Locally owned and operated by an NC State graduate, the Red and White Shop is your source for all things NC State. Just off campus in the Ridgewood Shopping Center at 3526 Wade Avenue, the Red and White Shop has everything the NC State fan needs. Sporting goods and memorabilia, your favorite NC State team apparel, tailgating essentials, ice pack gear. A proud sponsor of the NC State hockey team, a percentage of all ice pack sales go back to the team. Stop by today or visit us online. The Red and White Shop.
It's hard to always know what's going on with your kids. The Talk They Hear You mobile app and Screen for Success tool can help. The mobile app shows you how to turn everyday situations into opportunities to talk with your kids about alcohol and other drugs. Screen for Success helps you find out if your child needs more support by asking about their health, wellness, and well-being. Keep your kids safe and healthy. Download the free Talk They Hear You mobile app and start using Screen for Success today.
We've got a little less than 5 minutes left in this first intermission. NC State with a 4-2 lead over Texas A&M. Chris Lehman and Nick Prozzi back with you here on PackTV. And we're going to take a look ahead to period number two. And as we mentioned before the break, NC State still has 87 seconds of a power play left. And that's going to be important. I think if you're NC State, you got the goal back that you gave up after all the penalties. So that's good. But you want to keep pushing because, as we've seen, A&M can push back.
Yeah, and they have able to get that second goal on that power play is really, really beneficial for the Aggies to stay in this game. It's going to be about, can the Ice Pack put this game away and not have it kind of be one of those games that they've seen where it's been very close and sometimes it slips from their grasp. They have to keep their foot on the pedal, I think, for the next 40 minutes, and it all starts on this power play.
Yeah, and speaking of the power play, let's look at what NC State can do to put the puck in the back of the net. One thing that sticks out to me, and it's not necessarily something that NC State did too poorly in the first period, but face-off control really tilted in the Aggies' favor. You've got a center ice draw that you really need to win if you're NC State to get the power play established, get in and get established. And we didn't see a lot from the power play. It, of course, they scored a goal, but it only took 11 seconds. So it really wasn't about setting up the power play. It was a face-off play that was designed and worked out perfectly. So the power play is going to have to get working as well here.
Yeah, and I think the clearance from Texas A&M at the end of the period kind of shaved off a couple seconds, but being able to get that center ice faceoff, if you win it, it kind of offsets anything that was going to happen there. So if you win this opening faceoff, you're able to get set up. I think that's going to be a big thing. We've seen a lot of faceoff wins by the ice pack, especially at center ice, where they kind of take it and just run with it, quickly skate down the ice and get a quick shot. So if they're able to do that here with a man down for Texas A&M, expect for an open shot to happen.
Well, I think the other thing to keep an eye on in the second period, too, is the goaltending. We talk about a lot of penalties, a lot of power plays. Your best penalty killer a lot of times has to be your goaltender. And both of these goaltenders tonight have been good. Jake Cirkus was great last night, as was Isaac Toyer. So this goaltending is going to have to stay strong. And I think Addison Lawrence has done a really good job in net for NC State.
Yeah, he has, and I think both goalies have a message tonight. If you're not going to get a high-quality chance, you're not going to get it past us. All six goals have really been off high-quality chances or on a power play. So going into it, I think you just got to look for the open shot, take the high-quality chance, get some bodies in front, and that's going to be the key the rest of the game, I think.
So NC State with a power play to start the second. We'll be back with Puck Drop after this.
Locally owned and operated by an NC State graduate, the Red and White Shop is your source for all things NC State. Just off campus in the Ridgewood Shopping Center at 3526 Wade Avenue, the Red and White Shop has everything the NC State fan needs. Sporting goods and memorabilia, your favorite NC State team apparel, tailgating essentials, ice pack gear. A proud sponsor of the NC State hockey team, a percentage of all ice pack sales go back to the team. Stop by today or visit us online. The Red and White Shop.
From the top of D.H. Hill Library.
Don Diablo.
Oh, yeah, this is actually, like, in my studio. With
WKNC HD3 Raleigh.
Hey, what's up and what's going on, folks? It's Kid Kinetic, your boy, up here at the top of the hour. And guess what I got? A treat that's too sweet to beat.
This is Wolf Bites Radio.
Aw, that's really sweet.
NC State.
We've always been inviting, but we have a bigger story to tell. A place that welcomes you to be you. Fresh, high-quality ingredients. We got that. Go ahead, do your thing. Come on, let's get weird. We don't judge. Moe's wants you to come in with your crew and their appetites. Dine in, pick up, or order on the Moe Rewards app. Either way, don't just stroll in. Roll all in to Moe's Southwest Grill.
Have swapped ends, and we're getting set for period number two, NC State, Texas A&M. Round two, NC State with a 5-3 victory last night. We're almost to that scoring total here tonight, as it is 4-2 Ice Pack heading to the second 20 minutes. Chris Lehman and Nick Perossi with you here on PackTV. And Nick, as we talked about coming into the break, it's NC State with a power play to start the period.
Yeah, and they've got to really pounce on this power play and set the tone for the second period and really the rest of the game. If you're able to go up 3 goals, that will be massive. And I said during the intermission report, you got to keep your foot on the gas. You cannot let go. You cannot let Texas A&M have hope and hang around the rest of the game, or else they will make you pay.
So NC State's power play unit will consist of Zach Herman, Garrett Arini, Emery Oliver, Zach Robinson, and Nick Labrizzi. Marshall rushing to take the draw against Herman for Texas A&M, and NC State will control off the draw, and they'll start to work the power play. Again, a bit of an abbreviated power play for NC State, as they had 33 seconds of it in the first. And A&M will clear at the length of the ice, so NC State will regroup once again. It's always tough, and it's a bit of an advantage, not that you ever want to take a penalty, but taking a penalty at the end of a period can really help kill a penalty. There's a good chance in front for Emery Oliver. A big pad save is sealing off the bottom of the net there. Was Jake Cirkus. But it certainly helps to have that center ice faceoff to start a period. Always thought it'd be interesting to start a period in the offensive zone for a team with the power play. But Be an interesting way, I think. But it is NC State moving forward. Zach Robinson down the right wing. He'll wrap it around the wall with 20 seconds left on the man advantage. Thronson was looking for Arini. They couldn't connect. Helped along by Oliver. Back to Cade Cox on the blue line. He'll throw it towards the net. Pinball through a couple of sticks and still able to get a piece of it with Circus. A little bit of time left on the power play. Turnaround shot from Oliver. Fought off by the netminder Circus. And an offensive zone draw for NC State. I would imagine they're going to get back to their typical forward and forward lines defensive pairings here with just 6 seconds left on the power play.
Really good job, A&M, killing it off. Really two chances for NC State, but they were able to quickly get back down there and get those chances. But Texas A&M able to shoot the puck down twice. The intermission also helps with killing that penalty as we see 5-on-5 for the first time this period.
NC State with another face-off win. Good shot from an off angle. Going to be gloved and held by Circus. And we're back to 5-on-5 hockey.
Well, how about Texas A&M able to kill that penalty off? NC State not able to keep their foot on the gas. It's got to be all gas, no brakes, really, for the next couple of minutes. I think for NC State, they've got to take control of this game by the neck, or else A&M will come back.
Gauvet on the draw for the ice pack, unable to win that battle. But NC State returns the clearance all the way down. Back behind the net, McQuaig rims it around the wall and out. Gauvet gets a touch to it. It'll hop his stick, though, all the way back to Cade Cox, who sends it rink wide for Gauvea. Kaufman turns right into a big hit as he had a pass coming up the ice, lined up nicely by A.J. Cosman. NC State, though, looking to set up the forecheck in the offensive end. Kaufman putting pressure on. The clearance held in by Gauvea, wristed towards the net, deflected there by Shook, and the rebound will be held onto by Circus, but Shook with maybe a little extra hack there at the goaltender trying to knock it loose, and McQuaig takes exception.
Yeah, and there we go. Nick Shook, the one that started a lot of it last night, the instigator, if you will. He's instigating once again after the play, and Evan McQuaig, who just came out of the penalty box, took exception to that. And we're starting to see that chippiness bring in a little bit. It's going to be a little more chippy than last night if it does start to happen.
I'm not even necessarily sure those hits are necessarily called chippy. Just good, solid physical play. And we've seen that on both sides here today. A little bit more than we saw it last night. Bresingham takes a hit, trying to clear it in. Doesn't get it a long way, but far enough for Robinson. His pass across for Oliver off the mark. A&M clears it out, and Jackson Cowan will chase it down. We'll pitchfork it up that far wall. A little help there from Alex James, but it's pinched off there by Kale Morrow to hold the zone momentarily. Now it'll be chased down by Norwood of Texas A&M after an NC State clearance. Pass all the way across, off the boards and around Sowers, right to Jackson Cowan. NC State restarts with it. Alex James banks it off the wall back to the red line. Norwood in control for the Aggies. He'll lift it in behind the NC State goal. And A&M needs a change. NC State trying to take advantage of that. Stretch pass for Robinson, jumps his stick. Norwood gets to the loose puck first, picking up speed behind his own net, having trouble though controlling the puck as he runs into Robinson there. NC State back in possession. James hands it off at the blue line for McEnany, trying to sweep it across to Bressingham, but that pass disrupted. NC State trying to force it down that near wall. At the blue line now, Thronson throws it on goal, blockered away to the far side by Circus. At NC State, forecheck back to work though. Norwood tracking it down in the near corner for A&M. Beat to it though by NC State's Logan Todd. Good work here from NC State by a couple of different lines. They've made a line change in the midst of this offensive possession. Now it's Scott Daniel. He'll cycle to the middle. Looks for an open teammate there in Todd, and it just couldn't quite get through all the traffic. Aggies clear it out. Here's Labrizzi with the pass from his goaltender, Lawrence. Errant pass off the boards, taken back by Todd, though. He'll look to the middle for Daniel. That pass stolen away. A&M sends it all the way down again. Not enough juice on this one for icing. So play will continue. Labrizzi looking long up ice for Brenner, who chips it right out of play. And a neutral zone faceoff upcoming.
How about that offensive zone time for NC State? A little bit reminiscent of what we saw last night for a majority of the game. Getting A&M back on their heels a little bit. But just like last night, NC State not able to get a really a good high-quality chance in front of the net, and it results in no puck in the back of the net. And this will be a really good chance here for A&M with the line change. They're able to answer it back. They win a lot of face-offs. This one's actually going to come all the way back into the NC State zone for the face-off. So a really good chance here for the Aggies.
While the deflection came out in neutral ice, or at least to me looked like it came out in neutral ice, the pass originated in the NC State zone, so they'll bring it all the way back in. Quick shot off the draw for A&M. That blocked in traffic off the stick of A.J. Cosman. Good chance in front, but the bouncing puck can't be corralled by Spearman. NC State comes away with it. And they'll look for space. Labrizzi over to Thronson off the mark, and it'll be chipped up out of play by Thronson. So another offensive zone draw for A&M. And we've seen this on both sides, a little bit more for NC State here in this second period, but we've seen A&M able to do it a little bit throughout the night as well. Is once they get into the offensive zone, they make it difficult on you to get out.
Yeah, they really do. That forecheck, and both coaches really rave about each team's forechecks. They really love what they have, and that's really been the big story last night. It's a big story tonight.
Breaking their Arini, looking for the stretch pass, disrupted just enough by McQuaig, but NC State able to get to it first and negate the icing. No chance comes of it, though. Marshall rushing into the offensive end, trading places with Spearman, quick give and go. That's broken up, but A&M keeps the pressure. Marshall rushing lost his foot there. He would have had a good chance, and now NC State can move it back out. Arini on the near side. Steps around a hit and finds Herman, but NC State's in offsides. And I'm not sure if moving forward the ice pack, I believe it was Herman who made the pass over to the near side, but I'm not sure if anyone saw Brenner streaking down that far side that appeared at least to be a passing lane from my vantage point.
I think Arini was just sidestepping the hit. That's kind of what caused him to get his vision blocked by Brenner. Arini's taking a lot of big hits tonight, and I'm pretty sure he didn't want to take another one entering the offensive zone.
Good, solid win there from Joey Govea on the draw. He'll get it right back in the middle of the ice. Steps down that left wing now. Looking to the middle, has a teammate there. Shooks, one-timer, hits the skate of Norwood and stays out of the net. Forcing his way in, Ricky Froschnell gets it deep. Perry picks it up for the Aggies. And his breakout pass can't connect. NC State has it again. Nick Shook just about dispossessed, but he gets it back. Beautiful work from Shook, who gets a little touch pass there as well and lifts it up and over top. Trying to go short side on Circus. That will give numbers to A&M if they move quickly. Perry decides to send it into the corner as the Aggies need a change here. Out in front, open is Leone. He's already got one tonight, but his backhander steered wide. First one there is Jack Strong of NC State. He'll shovel it out. Aggies regroup at the defense. And now chipped out of play and face off.
Well, how about that play from Jack Strong in front of the net? He basically saves a goal. There's no one in between the A&M forward and Addison Lawrence. And Strong able to harass him from behind, able to get his stick in there. Really allows Lawrence to relax or diminish that scoring opportunity.
Face off right on top of the NC State blue line. Emery Oliver wins it. NC State seems to have evened out the face-off battle here in this second period. Definitely seem more tilted towards A&M in the first. Bressingham with a steal and a shot just inside the blue line. Handled easily by Circus. And another stoppage here with 13:45 left in the second.
On the way through, Bressingham's played the last couple of games. Coming back from his injury, it's really promising to see just how good he really is. And then I tell you what, the way he's been playing, I think he's due for a goal soon.
Cowan with the shot, looking for the deflection. Oliver unable to get a piece of it. NC State still in control. Oliver twirls around his man and holds the puck. Turns at the blue line. Fires from the high slot. Ooh, that one hit a man. And there's an A&M player. I believe it's Colson who's shaken up. And he went straight into that near corner. And from where we are, we can't really see it. I'm not 100% sure what happened. I know he took... I'm not sure whether it was the stick or the puck that caught him up high, but either way, he's in some noticeable pain here. And whatever it is, seems to be clutching at his neck a little bit. The good news is he seems like he should be all right. Just needs a minute to shake it off here, maybe get a look at from the trainer.
Another big loss for A&M. We saw a big injury last night. Two A&M players were shaken up. Hopefully he's able to return to the game. But you hate to see injuries like that, especially on block shots right in front of the net.
And Colson, and a good faceoff man tonight too. Off the draw, Robinson with the shot right into the chest protector of Circus, who holds on. And another draw for NC State.
Another big faceoff in the offensive end for the Ice Pack.
Oliver and Rushing squaring off. It's Rushing winning the draw for Texas A&M. Just sent around the wall, hit a couple of bodies, so no icing coming. As Cowan gets to it first for NC State, leaves for Bressingham. He'll move it forward, intended for Strong, but it got caught up in traffic. NC State will eventually regain control. Robinson steps around his man, steps past another. Backhand pass out in front, loose there in the crease, and pouncing on it was Circus. But another nice move there. Robinson did that last night. That's exactly how he set up Emory Oliver for the fifth goal, and he just about did it again.
Yeah, that second line for NC State, Bressingham, Oliver, Robinson, they have been phenomenal these past two games. And they already got a goal tonight with Oliver being interviewed during the intermission break. I mean, this second line has really brought a lot of juice and energy to this NC State offense, which they desperately need.
McEnany, Todd, and Daniel, the forward line now out there for NC State. Draw fought for over along the wall. NC State eventually comes away with it. Labrisi tees one up. Getting a stick in the way was Perry. And the shot doesn't make it to the net. We'll fight for it along that far wall. A&M has it pinned there. Good work with the stick from McEnany to jar it loose, but the Aggies have it back again. Norwood spins it up the near wall. It's sent right back to him. Now he's got a man open in neutral ice. Thronson breaks that up. Daniel feathers it back the other way. Bouncing puck, a little bit of trouble there for Kale Morrow, but he's eventually able to settle after the pressure from Todd, and now A&M forces their way in to the offensive end. Puck pinned by behind the net, knocked loose by Labrisi, who comes away with it. And he'll slowly work his way up the ice. Finds his D partner Thronson at the red line, and NC State comes in offsides. Puck will come back out to neutral ice with 11:56 to go in the second.
Yeah, Scott Daniel just not aware of what was going on to the left of him. He enters in a little bit early, and we'll come back down this neutral ice, but this game has kind of taken a neutral standpoint. Both teams are sort of unable to match each other. You kind of see that on the stat sheet other than the goals. I mean, shots right now are 18-16 NC State.
A&M advances right off the faceoff. NC State stalls it out, and it's chipped into the near corner. Ethan Chen looking in front. That pass skitters away where Arini can pick it up and skate it out. Getting pressure from behind. Nice back check from Leone, but his clearance stolen away, and Herman fires one just wide of the near post. NC State with a chance to put pressure on. Frosch holds the far blue line. His shot deflected wide. Around to the near wall. Again, it's NC State controlling as Cade Cox pinches at the defense, finds Herman back behind. He'll be stick-checked there and dispossessed. But NC State still holds his own. Once again, it's Frosch with the shot. This time, it'll be deflected out of play. And the two teams will get some line changes here.
NC State's getting a lot more opportunity, especially this period, than Texas A&M. A&M has had a lot of zone time offensively, but they're also doing a good job of limiting the amount of time NC State has on the offensive end.
Scrum off the draw. NC State earns the win. Cade Cox throws it down the wall for Nick Shook. Backhand pass, looking out in front. It'll be deflected back into the corner. Shook tries again, this time. It's out to the blue line where Cade Cox can pitch for it, get back behind. Good pressure from NC State. Govea absorbs a hit, finds Kaufman in the near corner. Left again for Govea. Turned out in front, and it directs in on goal, where Circus will cover it up.
NC State getting bodies in front of the net, but the high-quality scoring chances are not really there for NC State. And both goalies, especially Jake Circus tonight, is not letting those, really just putting the puck on that, that's not going to get to it. You're going to have to do something else.
This time it'll be A&M controlling off the draw. They'll have a chance to break it up and out. Bouncing puck ends up past Alex James. Cowan has to chase it down. He'll be pushed into the wall by Sowers. And now the clearance knocked down by Zach Colson. So good news for A&M fans. Colson, whether it was a stick or a puck that came up high on him, he was shaken up, but he's back out there. And now NC State advancing. James takes the shot off the waffle board of Jake Circus, and A&M gets it out to neutralize once more. Really can't do much past that, though. NC State reverses it back the other way. Shook from an off angle. Steered back behind the net. It looks for Kaufman in the corner. That pass was too strong. But the bouncing puck will end up on Kaufman's stick anyhow. Trying to throw one in from the blue line. Blocked on the way in by Sowers. He'll turn it over for Burdett now. Burdett fires a long one. Blocker down by Lawrence and into the near corner. Now it's Colson. Double teamed there by the NC State defense. Cowan sends it around the glass and out. Norwood receives it near the red line for the Aggies, finds his defensive partner in Morrow, and he sends it deep. Here's James. Cross-ice pass, finds a wide-open Emery Oliver with space. He'll break it in. Left top of the circle for Shook, and a great defensive effort from Marshall. Rushing as the rebound sent just wide. A couple of good chances there. After Rushing disrupted the one-time attempt from Shook, it came off the wall, and NC State had another opportunity. Inside their own, or down below their own goal line, I should say, Labrizzi sends a rainbow pass up and out. NC State comes away with it neutral ice, but Bresingham a little bit too quick getting back in as Oliver overstepped the puck initially. And it'll come back out on top of the A&M blue line.
Yeah, I thought Oliver was going to do a split there for a second, trying to get back. He's just going to get that skate over the blue line in time. But how about Circus not being able to find that puck and then the rebound? Really good job, NC State, setting up Shook for the one time when he was trailing the play. But the one time, or the rebound after it, just missing the net, that was Holden Kaufman. Big missed opportunity there for NC State.
Errant pass for Texas A&M is icing. Faceoff comes all the way down in front of the Aggie netminder, Jake Circus, who's had another solid outing tonight. Numbers don't look quite as good. 4 goals given up on 20 shots, but he's made some big ones as well to keep this a manageable deficit for the Aggies. Emery Oliver to face off against Matthew Perry. Oliver wins the draw. Now NC State will try and push it towards the net. Sent right back into the corner. Tied up in the skates with Perry. Now it's Robinson collecting the loose puck. Turnaround shot coming, and it's deflected up and over. It will stay in play, though. Bresingham back up to the blue line. He's got Thronson. D-to-D with Labrizzi. Under pressure, Labrizzi loses the handles, and it might be a 2-on-1 for Texas A&M here. Leone already with one. Well defended by Thronson, and now the pass stolen away by Robinson. He'll float it forward. Thronson in with Emery Oliver. Thronson with the shot. Off the stick of Circus and back behind. And again, it's Thronson. NC State defenseman doing a good job of getting this puck deep. NC State not able to make much happen with it, though. Here's Zach Robinson. Stick handling through traffic. Leaves it for Bresingham. Back to Robinson. He has it knocked off his stick in the high slot. Here's Perry for the Aggies. Forward for Leone, who gains the red line to get the chip in. And Texas A&M needs a change. Now Zach Robinson jams it up off the wall and out into neutral ice. These NC State players going to need a change here soon. We're starting to see them make the change. Logan Todd and McEnany out there as well. Robinson really the only tired forward, and he'll head off now. Stretch pass. Misses its target. Ricky Frosch comes away with it for NC State. Moved over to Thronson. And his pass forward not going to work out. Worked back here for Frosch. Backhanded forward for Todd. His centering pass knocked down. A&M has it again, but it's overskated, and now NC State back in control. Cade Cox off the wall looking for McEnany. He's tied up, but Logan Todd there to help out. He'll step to the middle. Disrupted nicely by Evan McQuaig, and the Aggies clear it once again, but this one's going to be too strong of a clearance, and they're going to have to keep tired bodies out there with the icing call.
Man, we're starting to see that shift once again. NC State is really just dominating the offensive zone. It's kind of going back to what we saw last night. They're able to get really good zone time, but A&M's defensive setup is just not really letting them get a high quality.
They'll return it. Cox sends it off the wall and deep. Too many A&M bodies there, though, and they'll clear it out. Frosch trying to hold the zone, does a nice job. Lost his stick, but at least momentarily held the zone. Now he'll kick it to Cox as his stick's still sitting on the ice. NC State making some changes as Herman deflects it deep. Arini will go in on the forecheck up against Evan McQuaid, who sends it around the wall to the far side. Frosch pinches in and gets a hold of it. And now Texas A&M once again sends it the length of the ice, and those tired bodies gonna have to stay out there. But this has been a good sequence, Dick, here for NC State. They've had a lot of sustained pressure.
They have, but it's going, once again, it's not like a broken record. Going back to last night and the high-quality scoring chances, like, not really have a good time generating those when they sustain this much time offensively. I want to see them do something different here off the faceoff. Maybe get a couple crashing bodies and look for a rebound.
Kaufman comes away with a loose puck off the drop. Back to Strong at the point. Again to Kaufman. He'll steer it down low. Shook wins the battle for the puck. Fires one off the iron. Might have caught the outside of the post, but it did sound like it rung off the post. NC State maintaining control. Turning with it, Govea. Leaves it there for Kaufman. He'll chip it deep, step around a hit, and then chase after that loose puck. Battling for it now with Zach Colson. Colson able to force it out. NC State back in possession, though, neutralized. Nick Shook into the offensive zone. Trying to fire it through the defenseman there in McQuaig. And a big hit behind the net for Kaufman. NC State not afraid to be physical tonight. Strong with a shot right into the body of McQuaig. But again, A&M unable to clear. But they'll block the shot from Strong. And here comes the Aggies. Fired away and whistled wide by Zach Colson. One of the better chances for Texas A&M this period. Strong to Govea. He'll stop just inside of the line. Leaves it there for Kaufman. Button hooks at the hashes. Looking for some help. He'll throw it behind where Govea can track it down. Back to the top of the circle near side. Shook shot. Pinballs through into the far corner. Cowan presses it deep. He'll tie up there with Kale Morrow. And they're in a bit of a stalemate here. Puck still stuck there, jammed loose though by Govea, who has possession at the moment. Too many Aggie defenders there, and they're going to be able to break it out now. Some speed as well for Burdett coming in. He's going to step around Bressingham. Big backhander. Lawrence had some trouble with it, but he's able to cover up, and a little extra poke there from Sowers is not taken too kindly by Jackson Cowan.
How about that save there by Addison Lawrence? What a play, though, getting down the ice that was by Burdett. I mean, just getting harassed all the way down there, going with the backhand, trying to catch Lawrence off guard, and he kind of did. Lawrence stopped about 95% of that puck, but the other 5% was trickling behind him, able to kind of trap that against his left blocker and keep the score at 4-2. That was probably, though, the best scoring chance A&M's seen this period.
Maybe another one brewing here, cutting down low with Spearman. He couldn't control it, but now Lawrence is without a stick as he got tangled up with the Aggie. Down low, NC State looking for a clearance here to get their netminder a stick back. He'll make a save right out in front without it. Low slot shot there from Jacob Smith, and it was sealed off nicely by Lawrence, who's got his stick back now. Great work from the NC State netminder. Loose puck squirts to the middle. Robinson has it. Stepping through pressure, Bressingham will leave it for Zach Robinson again. He fires away. Didn't get all of it. Ended up sending it wide, but the ice pack will hold the blue line as Oliver kicks it deep. He'll chase after it as Morrow swats it around the wall for A&M. And now it'll be pitchforked up and out. Labrizzi chasing after it.
Well, we talked about rhythm last night for goaltending. Addison Lawrence didn't really face a lot of shots up until those last couple chances for Texas A&M, and A&M very lucky there. They didn't get a penalty. Christian Spearman lifted and knocked Lawrence's stick out of his hand.
Here's Emery Oliver. Takes the shot from an off angle, whistles it wide, down to 3 minutes left in the second period. Leone with speed for the Aggies. Trying to step around the breezy, good stick from the NC State defenseman, and he'll tie up another man and leave the puck for Bressingham. Broken out to Robinson with space through the neutral zone. High slot, curl, Draghi scores right through the five hole. Circus gives up maybe the softest goal he's given up so far here this weekend, and it's 5-2 NC State.
Well, if you didn't go to the Village District Mo's today for your free queso, you can get it today thanks to some toe drag swag from Zach Robinson, or Z-Rob if you want to call him that. Really beautiful play by Zach Robinson, able to get that in, got the crowd and got the bench really all on their feet and celebrating a fantastic goal. And the Ice Pack finally delivered. It was a bit slog on that offensive end, but once again, like the majority of their even strength goals tonight, even going back to last night, it took a breakaway chance, an odd man rush, and that's why it's 5-2 right now.
NC State looking to get right back to work. The defenseman Ricky Frosch bodying up with Morrow. Squirts it loose to Logan Todd, and Cade Cox will chip it deep to hold the zone. Cox behind the net now. Cycling with it. Holds on to it at the blue line. Still Cox fires away off a stick and high out of play as Robbie Sowers got a stick to it. And 2:22 to go in this second period. An offensive zone faceoff coming up for the Ice Pack.
If you're A&M, you want to respond quickly. You still got another 2 minutes and 22 seconds left in this period. You got to respond with something. It doesn't have to be a goal, but it's got to be at least pressure.
One-time shot just over top from Ricky Frosch. Rebound chipped out of the zone by Sowers. And all the way down where Cade Cox can get there first for icing.
Yeah, Cox took exception there from Robbie Sowers. Wasn't going to hit him after the icing was called, but he kind of left his stick up in an area that may have hit Cade Cox, and he was not too thrilled about that with some choice words, it seems like, since the referee came in and stepped in to stop that discussion.
Traded a little paint, so to speak.
Yeah.
Just a sly little move there, too. Mm-hmm. It really looks like nothing, but just little things can get under your skin sometimes. NC State holds the zone off the draw. Norwood sends it right back up that far wall. He finds Burdett trying to turn on Frosch. He does so successfully. Puck jarred loose. It can be taken by Zach Colson across for Morrow off his skates. Now have some trouble handling it. NC State takes it back. Brenner forward for Herman. A little one-handed flip for Arini. Tried to steer one on goal. Too many A&M bodies there, though. And it's forced into the near corner. You get a look at it up close. Centering pass off an A&M stick, and now a breakout here for Jacob Smith. He's already got one tonight looking for help. It's not there, so he shoots and elevates it over the net. It'll ricochet all the way out of the zone. A&M regroups with 1:20 left in the period. Again, it's Smith backhanded in, chasing after it now. McQuaig is the first to it behind the goal. Ricky Frosch there to disrupt, but McQuaig holds on, and his pass out to the blue line misses the outstretched stick of Jacob Smith. Free clearance for NC State, free change, but they changed everybody, and now A&M trying to turn it into a fire sale. They're unable to connect, though. NC State back in position again, and A&M will reset back in their defensive end. Cosman slaps it up the wall. Getting a skate to it there was Alex James. He kicks it to Nick Shook, who fires it all the way down. 40 seconds left in the period now. Breakout pass knocked down by Holden Kaufman of NC State. Left for Govea, who's pickpocketed by Rushing. He needs a change, so he sends it behind the NC State net. Cowan first there for the Ice Pack. Stretch pass coming from James, moving forward for Kaufman with some space. Stops top of the far circle. Looking back to the middle for Cowan. That pass is deflected away. Ethan Chen has it for A&M. He'll lift it all the way out. This one in on goal on Addison Lawrence, and he'll melt it down for a faceoff.
Final 13 seconds. A&M, I mentioned it, they got to do something to respond. They had a couple scoring chances, but they were messed up. A long pass too far. NC State got a stick in the way. They weren't able to get it going. I think their best chance was that play where they're trying to get it to the point, but the pass went all the way back down to their own end behind their own net because Christian Spearman was getting wide open as he lurked towards the slot. It was a big missed opportunity for the Aggies. They've got 13 seconds. They've got to try to do something, get Lawrence uncomfortable here.
The offensive zone draw. Cowan sends it off the glass and out. Bouncing puck is not going to get in for icing. Brenner with some pressure throws the defenseman Morrow into his own goalie. NC State's got it. Shot from Brenner. Blocked on the way in. NC State with the rebound. Now Emery Oliver swats at it, but NC State out of time. It was a stalemate for most of the period, but the Ice Pack breakthrough again with just under 3 minutes to go in the second. It was Zach Robinson adding to the NC State lead, 5-2, and
Nick, if you're the Pack, you're a pretty solid period. You can't complain when you extend the lead.
No, you can. In a good first 10 minutes of that period, they weren't really able to get much going. It was a pretty good even period up until NC State started doing what they did last night, and what they did so well was dominating the forecheck, not letting A&M escape their own offensive end. And they didn't get a goal out of doing that, but they got a goal on an odd man rush. And you got to be pretty proud when you have a goal in the column and the other team doesn't.
So a 17-minute break as they'll clean up the ice and get set for period number three. But NC State in control, 5-2 over A&M after 40 minutes.
Locally owned and operated by an NC State graduate, the Red and White Shop is your source for all things NC State. Just off campus in the Ridgewood Shopping Center at 3526 Wade Avenue, the Red and White Shop has everything the NC State fan needs. Sporting goods and memorabilia, your favorite NC State team apparel, tailgating essentials, ice pack gear. A proud sponsor of the NC State hockey team, a percentage of all ice pack sales go back to the team. Stop by today or visit us online. The Red and White Shop. Locally owned and operated by an NC State graduate, the Red and White Shop is your source for all things NC State. Just off campus in the Ridgewood Shopping Center at 3526 Wade Avenue, the Red and White Shop has everything the NC State fan needs. Sporting goods and memorabilia, your favorite NC State team apparel, tailgating essentials, ice pack gear. A proud sponsor of the NC State hockey team, a percentage of all ice pack sales go back to the team. Stop by today or visit us online. The Red and White Shop.
From the top of D.H. Hill Library,
Don Diablo.
Oh, yeah, this is actually like in my studio. With
WKNC HD3 Raleigh.
Hey, what's up and what's going on, folks? This is Kid Kinetic, your boy, up here at the top of the hour. And guess what I got? A treat that's too sweet to beat.
This is Wolf Bites Radio.
Aw, that's really sweet.
NC State.
We've always been inviting, but we have a bigger story to tell. A place that welcomes you to be you. Fresh, high-quality ingredients. We got that. Go ahead, do your thing. Come on, let's get weird. We don't judge. Moe's wants you to come in with your crew and their appetites. Dine in, pick up, or order on the Moe Rewards app. Either way, don't just stroll in. Roll all in to Moe's Southwest Grill.
NC State with a 5-2 lead over Texas A&M after 40 minutes. Chris Lehman, Nick Perazzi with you here at the second intermission at Invisalign Arena. And Nick, we talked about how eventful that first period was, and you know, there were some things that happened in the second period, but it certainly wasn't as much as we saw in the first, and it really came down to the goaltending, I think, in that period.
It did, and I think something that kind of gets underlooked, we didn't really mention it, there were no penalties that period. Yep. Something we saw six of in the first period. We saw none in the second period. So both teams able to keep their composure in check. We did see a lot of big hits. But you mentioned that goaltending. And like we said in the last intermission, you're not going to get an easy one by us, is what both goalies were saying. Zach Robinson's goal, it wasn't an easy one. It was on an odd man rush. And boy, was that a beauty.
Yeah, I think if you're Jake Cirkus there, you might want that one back. Mm-hmm. It is a little bit harder, I think, than it looks. That little drag, yep. You hear it talked about a lot in the NHL, particularly with a new draft pick in Connor Bedard, his ability to change the angle. You talk about Austin Matthews with that as well. Mm-hmm. Just that little 1 foot, foot and a half, 2 feet
angle change makes a big difference, and I think that's a big reason why Robinson was able to sneak it underneath and pick up that extra goal. But I think the other thing about that is that's an important goal if you're NC State. The game was turning into, I said a couple times, turning into a stalemate. It was starting to slow down. You were getting into that, wasn't a slog, but it was into that kind of really comfortable rhythm where you can get too comfortable. So I think to get that goal if you're NC State, kind of jar you out of that a little bit, get you back up and going a little bit, maybe punch a little bit extra adrenaline into the system is going to be helpful for the third.
Yeah, and I always like that saying, all gas, no brakes. And NC State seemed like they're letting up on the gas a little bit, but with that other goal, like I mentioned, they really needed that. They can't let A&M sit around and get hope and let them get back in this game. And I think that fifth goal that they have really helped them out. I think A&M's going into this intermission thinking we're down three. We have to do something to get back. One more by NC State, and it's going to be a tough mountain to climb for A&M if they want a chance back in this game.
Well, NC State certainly in the driver's seat with just 20 minutes left. We're going to take a quick break. We'll have Eric Mura, coach for NC State, when we come back.
Locally owned and operated by an NC State graduate, the Red and White Shop is your source for all things NC State. Just off campus in the Ridgewood Shopping Center at 3526 Wade Avenue, the Red and White Shop has everything the NC State fan needs. Sporting goods and memorabilia, your favorite NC State team apparel, tailgating essentials, ice pack gear. A proud sponsor of the NC State hockey team, a percentage of all ice pack sales go back to the team. Stop by today or visit us online. The Red and White Shop.
Welcome to Moe's! At Moe's, we've always been inviting, but we have a bigger story to tell. A place that welcomes you to be you. Fresh, high-quality ingredients. We got that. Go ahead, do your thing. Come on, let's get weird. We don't judge. Moe's wants you to come in with your crew and their appetites. Dine in, pick up, or order on the Moe Rewards app. Either way, don't just stroll in. Roll all in to Moe's Southwest Grill.
It's time to talk about men's mental health.
80% of suicides are done by men.
Men are 3 times less likely to ask for help if they are struggling.
One man every minute commits suicide.
Men are more likely to suffer from substance abuse disorders.
Alcohol kills 6 times more men than women.
Men are 3 times less likely to ask for help if they are struggling.
We've never needed each other more
than we do right now.
It's okay to not be okay.
It's okay to talk about how you feel.
Being silent doesn't mean you are being strong.
This is a movement for men's health.
The silence needs to be broken.
Men need support too.
The stigma.
The stigma.
The stigma.
The stigma.
The stigma.
The stigma.
The stigma ends here.
The stigma ends here.
Back here in Invisalign Arena with Coach Eric Mura. Going back to that last period, Eric, you guys really needed a goal kind of to get that extra step and get a comfortable padding to the lead. How important is that goal, especially the way it came?
Oh, I mean, it's very important. I think any time that we can get up, you know, more than 2 goals, like they say in hockey, 2 goals is the worst lead, right? So anything to get the extra goal is really good. I mean, I think we outshot them 11-3 that period. So it's kind of one of those things. It's like, you know, we're grinding, and then we're trying to, you know, get those goals. So it was huge for our team.
So going into that period, there were 6 penalties combined by both teams that first period, 0 by both teams the last period. We even saw a lot of big hits that last period. Mm-hmm. So what was kind of the message about keeping it clean going into that second period?
Yeah, so I mean, both teams are clean, even from yesterday's game, right? It was a clean, hard-fought game. So we kind of go in the locker room and say, like, hey, refs got a little bit of a tight strike zone, so let's kind of dial it back, you know, play between the whistles, play hard. After that, kind of let it go and then let the game kind of happen. So it's just a mental thing that we just have to keep on, you know, reiterating to the guys and making sure that, hey, like, you know, the refs got a tight strike zone. So,
going into this third period, final question I'll ask you, going into this third period, what's going to be the message? What do you guys need to work on going into this third period? And what's going to be the key to victory hanging on to this lead?
So I think it's clean the D zone up, right? I think there's a couple of times we left guys wide open in the front on, and that's kind of ideally not what we want to do, right? Giving them the high opportunity shots. So I'm really focused on the D zone, getting some more shots on towards the net. And honestly, if we get 1 or 2 more, I think that might open up the floodgates a little bit more. And then also it kind of gives us a little more breathing room in the D zone.
Yeah, Jack Strong made a really good play. A man was left wide open in front of the net for A&M. Strong got his stick there, prohibited a good shot chance for A&M. So that's something you guys definitely need to work on. Mm-hmm. We'll be back after this. Coach Eric Mura with me.
from the top of D.H. Hill Library.
Don Diablo.
Oh, yeah, this is actually, like, in my studio. With
WKNC HD3 Raleigh.
Hey, what's up and what's going on, folks? This is Kid Kinetic, your boy, up here at the top of the hour. And guess what I got? A treat that's too sweet to beat.
This is Wolf Bites Radio.
Aw, that's really sweet.
NC State.
That welcomes you to be you. Fresh, high-quality ingredients. We got that. Go ahead, do your thing. Come on, let's get weird. We don't judge. Moe's wants you to come in with your crew and their appetites. Dine in, pick up, or order on the Moe Rewards app. Either way, don't just stroll in. Roll all in to Moe's Southwest Grill.
I'm with 2018 lacrosse national champion Christian Gaudy for the FDA's Don't Get Burned Sunscreen Challenge.
Bring it, Daryl.
She's tough, but I won't get burned today. I'm using a broad-spectrum sunscreen.
The FDA recommends broad-spectrum sunscreens with an SPF of 15 or higher with other sun protection measures to reduce the risk of sunburn and skin cancer.
You smoked me, Kristen.
That's because I use sunscreen, so I wouldn't get burned by you and the sun.
Broad-spectrum sunscreen. It's a winning play every time.
Chris Lehman and Nick Prozzi back with you here on PackTV. NC State with a 5-2 lead over Texas A&M after two periods. Nick, you were just able to talk with assistant coach Eric Mira of NC State. One of the things he talked about was defensive zone, cleaning things up a little bit. And to me, that's been the strength, not necessarily the defensive zone, but the strength for both teams has been when they get it in, they've made it hard to get for the other team to break it back out.
Yeah, it's really just the forechecks for both teams. Not letting you get that breakout pass into the neutral zone has been a really key point of emphasis. Even last night when NC State dominated the offensive end, A&M wasn't able to get it out. And towards the end of that period, we saw NC State dominate the offensive end. A&M wasn't able to break it out. But the chances were there at A&M for the end of the period. The problem was they just weren't crisp with their passes. They weren't on the same page. And it left a lot of scoring chances up that weren't even – a shot wasn't even taken there.
And one of the other things that you had mentioned in our first break in the second intermission was the physicality. There wasn't a lack of physicality despite the lack of penalties. There were a lot of good, hard, clean hits. So if you're both teams, you got to keep your head on a swivel because the hits are coming and they're not resulting in penalties. They're good hits.
No, they're not. I think that's a big key too. Really, all the hits this game, minus a couple that actually were penalties, they haven't really been, even the penalties that were penalties, they haven't been out of anger. They've kind of just been out of playing the game of hockey. And we even saw one hit where an A&M player was kind of saying, hey, my bad, that's my bad, hitting you like that. I'm going to the box for it. So going into that last period, we did see some extracurriculars, especially with Robbie Sowers, who was someone that was a little pain in the neck yesterday for NC State. So going into this third period, I think A&M's going to try to get something fired up, maybe make a line change trying to get back in this game, or maybe they take a big penalty or make a big hit, take that risk.
Well, another thing to keep an eye on, we've certainly sung the praises of both goalies tonight, Addison Lawrence is going to have a bit of a challenge, not because of anything that he's done, but the lack of work that he's had. I was talking with Coach Murray just after you had talked with him. Only three shots given up that period by NC State, so it looked a little bit more like those first and second periods. Lawrence did a good job making the saves he needed to, but he did look just a tad shaky. That one slipped by him a bit. He was able to get it back and control the rebound, but those are the kind of things you have to stay on your toes for, because right now NC State, they've been controlling play. They haven't had it in the offensive zone quite as much as they did in the game last night, but they are still making it difficult on A&M to create offense.
Yeah, and I think the thing is Addison Lawrence has made the big save tonight. We've seen about three or four big saves, and really the two that have gone by him right now, both one on the power play and one was just a quick one that got by him. He's kind of got locked in, though, and we mentioned it last night with rhythm with Isaac Toyer. It's kind of hard when you only face three shots in a period. He faced a lot of good shots, though, and I think that's going to be a problem going into this third. However, he stepped up to the challenge, so maybe it won't be as big as a problem as one might think.
I think to build off of that as well, if you're NC State, you got to make sure that you keep the puck out of the middle, and you got to keep an eye on what those guys on A&M are doing, because there are some guys out there. We've seen Smith had a great shot, that first one that got by Addison Lawrence, great shot. We obviously know Robbie Sowers has a great shot. He put a couple of nice ones past Isaac Toyer last night. And then you've got some other guys to keep an eye on as well. Marshall Rushing has been a pest. He's a playmaker. He can set things up for those two guys we mentioned to finish. Mason Burdett, another one. Number six on Texas A&M. Burdett did an excellent job. Very powerful, physical. Did a good job of breaking it into the zone. So if you're NC State, we talked about the fact that I think that last goal helped them. Obviously, anytime you have a goal, that's a good thing. But it kind of shakes you out of that rhythm that you can get too comfortable in, and that can allow A&M to get back into this hockey game. I think that's the biggest thing to avoid if you're NC State. You can't get lulled to sleep a little bit by the flow of the game. You've got to keep up the energy level. You've got to keep up the tempo and dictate what Texas A&M does, not let them dictate to you how the game is going to go.
And I think for Texas A&M going into this period, you've got to get Robbie Sowers the puck more. Really haven't said his name that much tonight. He had two goals last night. We didn't say Marshall Rushing's name last night. We said his name twice today with two beautiful assists. So going into this third period, I think A&M's got to give it to their playmakers. We've seen a lot of great chances, but maybe Robbie Sowers needs to puck a little more in the offensive end.
Well, and one thing, part of the reason I think we haven't heard as much from Sowers, and you know, I think we're going to hear his name again in this third period. He's going to try something. But if you're NC State, I think you talked about the fact that two nights in a row that these two teams have played, especially early on, you could tell they were familiar with each other after last night. They were able to pick up on tendencies, pick up on strengths and weaknesses. And I think NC State, to some extent, it's not like they've, you know, completely abandoned a game plan and marked Sowers. There's no reason to do that. But I do think they've done a good job of keeping him out of those areas. That top of the circle, high slot area is his kitchen. That's where he likes to work. And NC State has not really allowed him maybe one, two shots at most.
Yeah, and I think we saw that last night as well, taking away Marshall Rushing's game a little bit. Yep. Now they focus on Robbie Sowers, who had the two goals and was a problem last night. For A&M, maybe you try getting them in different areas of the ice. Maybe you set up a play for them to where NC State won't remember where he is and kind of move him around the ice to get him set up in that area with a play to give him a quick one-timer.
Well, for NC State, it's all about finishing this one off. They won 5-3 last night, a 5-2 lead headed to the third when we come back.
From the top of D.H. Hill Library.
Don Diablo.
Oh, yeah, this is actually, like, in my studio. With
WKNC HD3 Raleigh.
Hey, what's up and what's going on, folks? This is Kid Kinetic, your boy, up here at the top of the hour. And guess what I got? A treat that's too sweet to beat.
This is Wolf Bites Radio.
Aw, that's really sweet.
NC State.
That welcomes you to be you. Fresh, high-quality ingredients. We got that. Go ahead, do your thing. Come on, let's get weird. We don't judge. Moe's wants you to come in with your crew and their appetites. Dine in, pick up, or order on the Moe Rewards app. Either way, don't just stroll in. Roll all in to Moe's Southwest Grill.
I'm with 2018 lacrosse national champion Christian Gaudy for the FDA's Don't Get Burned Sunscreen Challenge.
Bring it, Daryl.
She's tough, but I won't get...
40 minutes down, 20 to go here at Invisalign Arena. Chris Lehman and Nick Perazzi with you here on PackTV. NC State extended their lead with a goal in the second period. But they've got to finish things off, as we talked about during that intermission. This is an A&M team that can strike back. We saw it last night. They didn't need a lot of chances to score, just two goals or just three shots to score two goals in the first period yesterday. So if they have the opportunities, they can finish them. NC State moving right to left in this third and final period. A&M advances right off the draw, and a firing shot from the far side is knocked down by Addison Lawrence. A good quick chance there for Texas A&M.
trying to get Lawrence off guard there. I really like that opening faceoff move that they did, able to quickly get that line. Something we've seen NC State do a lot. I think Texas A&M is going to start ripping it on net more, since Lawrence hasn't really faced a lot of shots in a long time.
NC State controls off this draw, broken out with the pass from Frosch up to Brenner. Slides a pass through to Arini, and he scores! I'm not sure how it got through Circus, but it did, and a quick strike 17 seconds into the period for a number 17, and it's 6-2.
Well, that four-goal lead gives you pretty good room. Arini, I think he just goes five-hole there, and Circus just kind of goes back on it, keeps going back on it. It just kind of snuck on through a little bit in between the legs, and Circus moving back since Arini was getting close. It's kind of the reason why he just kind of pushed it on into his own net. And the Pack will take it any way they can. They're up 6-2. And as for A&M, you had that quick start on the other end, and then just like that, a pass kind of just trickles on through to Arini. He's the captain for a reason, and now you're down four.
NC State wins the draw, immediately advances into the offensive end, but A&M clears it right back to neutral ice. Here's Brenner, who assisted on the last goal. He'll chip and chase, but he's bodied off the puck there by Jacob Smith, and the Aggies will look to break out. Spearman's deflected pass in the middle, finds an ice pack player. That's Brenner, who's spun down after taking the shot, and he's a little bit slow getting up. Keep an eye on Brenner headed to the bench, but NC State back in control on their own end. Soft pass to Bresingham from Labrizzi. Cross ice for Kaufman as NC State's making a line change. Kaufman weaving through traffic. High slot, takes the shot. It'll be held on to nicely by Circus. It caught him up high. And another offensive zone draw here for the Pack.
Yeah, I'm not really sure about the injury for Aiden Brenner. It looked like he was holding his head a little bit. And that's what it seemed like at first, like he went down. Don't want to speculate, though. Hopefully he's able to quickly back on the out of the ice quickly, but for A&M, you're not really getting that offensive zone time again, and NC State's forecheck has kind of been dominating you. You kind of see it here, forcing another turnover.
You get tangled up over in the far corner, comes loose, NC State's got it. Slap shot from the point for Kaufman, sticked away by Circus. A&M back in control. Up the near side for Leone, touched along for Matthew Perry, 2-on-2 coming forward. Leone takes a shot. Going down to Anita Block, it was Thronson. He'll collect it in the corner and move it forward, trying to connect there with Govea, but can't. NC State will have to retry the breakout. This time, it's moved forward by Govea. Crosses over past the defenseman. Backhand pass in front, denied nicely by number. I believe that was Spearman who made that play. Here's Leone stepping into the zone. He'll be stood up right at the blue line. NC State takes over. Cowan behind his own net. Double team there. Puck pops loose out in front of the net. NC State gets to it first. And it'll be Nick Shook advancing it into neutral ice before he loses possession. Now Cosman looking forward, trying to connect with Cade Willis. That's a little bit too long. NC State back in control. Emery Oliver. Slap pass to Robinson. Bad angle. Robinson backhand try. Another stab at it. And Circus is there for both of them. Another faceoff coming up for NC State in the offensive zone. NC State has done a really good job. Talked about last night when they weren't scoring, getting into the front, into that low slot area right in front of the net. They weren't doing all that well. They've done a great job tonight, particularly early in this period.
They have, and then on last play, Circus, give credit to him. He did a really good job not letting that cross crease pass go to Bressingham, keeping it, forcing Robinson to keep it.
Zach Robinson throws it off the glass behind the net. Oliver tracks it down there for State. Had some trouble with it, caught in his skates, regroups though. Throws it to the high slot, not sure Robinson was expecting it. And A&M clears it out as Sowers chips it to the red line. NC State back in. Quick shot from the high slot from Robinson, missed wide. He'll get it back in the corner, immediately taken away, swept out of the zone by A&M's Evan McQuaid. Now Sowers with the forecheck at the blue line. Puck left there as NC State had some trouble connecting, but they'll get it back. Bressingham receives the touch pass from McEnany and returns the favor. Thomas McEnany cycles behind, looking out in front, trying to connect with Todd. That's intercepted. Here goes Robbie Sowers. Good stick there from Cade Cox to knock it off of his tape. And now it looks like the puck came out and back in, so A&M is offsides.
Well, B&M, they aren't able to get it going on the offensive end and break out into the neutral zone. We saw their two goals early on last night were off the off-man rush. They might have to start relying on that when you're down by four. It's something that you really don't want to do at all. You want to keep pressuring them with offensive zone time if you want a chance to come back.
A&M advances into the offensive zone off the draw. Cade Cox finds it behind the net for State. Up the far wall, slapped out by Logan Todd. And the Aggies track it down. Spearman. Little chip pass over to Morrow. He takes a hit as he headmans the puck for Smith. It's directed in on Lawrence. He'll set it up for Cox. Back up the near wall. NC State closed off there. They'll have to try the breakout again. Scott Daniel pinned behind the net, lost the puck. It pops out to the top of the near circle, and a one-timer from Morrow is squeezed in the glove by Addison Lawrence.
Key faceoff coming up for A&M. They're going to get a new line in as well, and NC State will get a fresh five on the ice too. But I think if they're able to win this faceoff, you've got to set up the offense. This is a really big faceoff, because otherwise we've seen them have trouble getting down on this end, and if NC State's able to win and get down the ice, they're going to have another hard time getting it back here. So this is a really good opportunity for Texas A&M if they can win the draw.
It'll be lifted up and out. Looks like it hit the NC State bench, though, and that'll be out of play. Faceoff back in the ice pack zone.
Bit of a second chance here for A&M. They lost that first faceoff. They're going to have another one back in the exact same circle. Try to redeem yourself here if you're the Aggies. Get something going here, because sooner or later you're going to have to get a goal, or else it's going to be really hard.
NC State with another win on the defensive zone draw. Gloving it down, Morrow. Bodied up there by Arini, and the puck squirts loose. A&M advances it in. Matthew Perry, though, dispossessed. NC State reverses it. Arini rubbed off the puck there. Knocked back towards the blue line, where Aiden Brenner holds the zone. Talked about him taking a hard hit earlier. He's back on the ice, though. Here's big-time numbers for A&M. Leone looking to the middle, and he's going to get tangled up. His intended target's going to get tangled up with Addison Lawrence, and nothing comes of it. Now NC State putting the pressure on below the goal line. Herman out in front, the one-timer for Marini. Blocker down by the goaltender Circus. And now Norwood will chip it out, trying to find Ethan Chen. He can't glove it down. NC State will send it deep and get a change.
A&M really lucky. Nicholas Leone's still out there right now. Him and Labrizi were going at it. He gave a couple whacks and knocked him down from behind. The ref was right in front of them, but let them play.
Kaufman now in control for the ice pack. Leaves it along the wall for Govea. Back up top, Cowan. Walks the line, wrists one in on goal, and it'll be gloved by Circus, but Nick Shook getting into it in the high slot. You talked about the hand gestures last night can get you in some trouble. And a little bit of a wave there from Shook. That, a little bit more than the taunting to me, or the pointing can be a little bit more of an indicator of taunting, but something Nick Shook has done really well. He took a couple penalties over the course of these two games, but he's done a pretty good job of walking the line and really getting under the skin of these Aggies players.
Man, the save player from Texas A&M getting into it with Shook and giving him a little gesture.
So NC State back in control. Kaufman has it off the draw. Looking for some help, he finds Shook on the near side. He'll stop in the corner, turning back up the wall, has some space, decides to throw it towards the net, misses wide, but Govea has the rebound. He finds Shook again, trying to work his way through traffic, knocked off his stick. Govea holds the blue line, though. Now Kaufman, across for Jack Strong. He'll look it over. Fakes the pass, drags it down low, finds Nick Shook. Centered out in front, nobody in the slot, though, with an ice pack jersey. And now Burdett can carry it out for Texas A&M. Throws it off the wall for Sowers, who fires away. And again, it'll be swallowed up by Addison Lawrence. Lawrence doing an excellent job tonight. He, by the numbers, has been the best goaltender for NC State so far this season. 2.59 goals against average is a team best, as well as his .917 save percentage. And he's about right on that mark tonight. Two goals given up on 21 shots. Ice pack with a comfortable 6-2 lead. They added to it early in the third period on a goal by Garrett Arini. Now another icing, and it comes all the way back once more.
Going back to Lawrence's play, when you look at his record, though, he's 2-3 on the year, 7 games played. But with those stats, would not expect that. So Lawrence has played those games that have been 2-1, 3-2, but he's kept the Pack in it every single game. And right now, because of their offensive explosion tonight, he's got the Pack up 4 with only 2 by him.
Goal support has certainly been there for Addison Lawrence tonight, as it was for Isaac Toyer, even though it took a while last night. So NC State pushes it out into neutral ice. A pinching Jake Norwood, though, slows down the Ice Pack attack. They'll try again. Robinson high slot shot, steered away by the stick of Circus and into the near corner. Therefore, Emery Oliver finds Frosch at the blue line. His shot hits a skate and ricochets to the far side corner. Pressingham coming away with it for the Ice Pack. Has it knocked off his stick. Jacob Smith trying to keep him away from the puck. Had some trouble with it, but Smith eventually knocked it out of the zone. But again, NC State really closing things off around the red line and making it difficult on A&M to move through neutral ice. Good step up there by Scott Daniel to intercept the breakout pass and send it in once more. Logan Todd in to help out on the forecheck as Jake Norwood's breakout pass is stolen by Cade Cox. He'll fire one at the net, blockered away there by Circus. And now A&M sends it the length of the rink. Getting a touch to it, though, was Ethan Chen to negate the icing call. Now he'll knock down Cade Cox, forces a turnover, and the centering pass goes through the skates of Leone. NC State dodges one there, and they'll come back the other way. Cox looking to the middle, hits the skates of the defenseman there in Matthew Fillick. And A&M directs it out into neutral ice again. Bronson now looking to the middle for Daniel. Off his stick and into the A&M end where Fillick can clear it out once more. Bronson reloads. This time he gains the red line and chips it in. NC State in on the forecheck. Daniel there along with McEnany forced over to the near wall. McEnany swats it back around behind the goal. Logan Todd in on the forecheck against Fillick now. Todd keeps it alive. He finds Daniel down below the goal line. Daniel and Todd doing good work down there right now. Chen looking to clear it out, and he'll shovel it back out to center ice once again. And once again, NC State turns it right back. Now it's Herman, steps to the net, bodied down by the goaltender. Good sustained attack here from the Ice Pack. Now Arini circling behind, looking up top. He's got Labrizzi back down the near side wall. He'll sidestep a check, gets back to the puck, finds Herman. Backhand pass for Brenner. It got popped up in the air, still loose in the slot area right now. Brenner comes away with it. Couldn't get a shot away, though, and now NC State having to close it off on the blue line. The captain, Arini, does so momentarily, but A&M tired. They're not going to try and advance it. They're just going to chip it out and get a change here.
The goal came off his line on the Texas A&M, and then the ref mid-play decided he'll just fix it instead of calling it, but that could have been a really big chance there for A&M if NC State was able to net it or have an even better chance. A&M could have protested that since the goal was off its line.
Another icing here on NC State. I think in that situation, a lot of times the goal coming off its moorings is a situational thing. On it, if it comes just off, very minor, not affecting the play, play will continue, official will fix it, no issue. If it comes off by a large margin, as a quick shot off the draw, gets through traffic and Lawrence makes the save, but if it comes off in the middle of a play right around the net, they will blow it dead. So play continues. NC State scores. This time it's Aiden Brenner. A beautiful feed from Zach Herman. All he had to do was deflect it over the shoulder of Circus, and it's 7-2.
How about this goal? Watch Herman go down the left side. He just slings it in front. A lot of heat and mustard on that pass. And you had a little bit of traffic there as well in the way, but it ends up in Aiden Brenner's, or on Aiden Brenner's stick, I should say, and it's a simple flick up to get that one in the back of the net. Now, how about that, really, the second, third line for NC State has really shown a lot today. Two goals for both lines tonight. Brenner getting the second one after Arini got the first for that third line.
I think that speaks to the depth of this NC State team, the fact that you can put Zach Herman and Garrett Arini along with Aiden Brenner on that third line. And it's just the way they're listed out on the lineup card. They've certainly got plenty of playing time, but you know, when you're that deep, it's certainly an advantage if you're NC State. Govea with an offensive zone draw up against Texas A&M's Marshall rushing. Rushing victorious on that faceoff. A&M breaks out. Clean movement through the neutral zone this time as well. Spearman receives the pass from Smith out in front. Can't direct it on goal. Morrow comes down to help out. Looking into the middle for rushing. Can't get the shot away. Puck directed out into neutral ice. Kaufman with the steal. He'll step around his defender. Finds an open man and shook. Shot pad save made by Circus. And Kaufman couldn't get a hold of the rebound. Now it's Govea. Left for Shook in the far blue line. Into the middle. High slot shot coming from Kaufman. Hits the stick of Norwood and deflects wide. Now the Aggies clear it out to the neutral zone once more. Alex James gloves it down. Finds Shook, who takes a shot from the top of the far circle. Again, it caught traffic and didn't make it to the net. Cowan now. And NC State just seems to be cycling defensemen into the zone and back out with the way that they're collecting the puck at the red line and just carrying it in. Here's Ethan Chen. Finds Leone. Fires away from the near circle. That one hit Shook, and NC State will move it out. Robinson found a lane through traffic, carries it in, but standing tall in the slot was Fillick to take it away for the Aggies, and he'll lug it all the way up the ice. Thrown towards goal. That hit a body as Cade Cox got in the way, and it's out of play for a faceoff in the NC State zone. I do wonder, it certainly at this point it doesn't look like it's at the forefront of the A&M coaching staff's mind, but when we talked to them yesterday, they mentioned in all likelihood Circus is going to get the nod for all three games this weekend. Do you maybe rest him in a five-goal game and just not because of the way he's played, but just because you feel like you're going to need him tomorrow against North Carolina? Do you rest him and give him a break? Here comes Cade Cox for NC State. Aggressive through the neutral zone. He'll carry it back behind and hold on to it. Over to Brenner. He'll take the shot. Low one. Hit legs on the way in. Big hit by Robinson. Or on Robinson, I should say, as he tried to put some pressure on the corner. NC State still holds the zone, though. Frosch sends it back behind the goal. Fillick gets to it first, and now we've got a penalty coming up on Texas A&M. It was getting pretty physical, and the officials decide to calm things down a little bit, but it'll be a cross-checking penalty and a two-minute power play for NC State.
Yeah.
Something, just the frustration starting to boil over. But I want to go back to your discussion about Circus. I think A&M taking him out now kind of be admitting defeat in a sense. And maybe they don't want their players to kind of just say, all right, we're going to lose. Let's just start resting people. They want to play hard. They want to play the whole 60 minutes as hard as they can. So I think that's a little bit of it. But I think the discussion does have to come up because he has allowed seven. Something's going on with the penalty box. It won't open. Jamming a stick in there will help open it. But
well, there is a little button down there that you can press. And I've seen a couple A&M players have some trouble with it. We mentioned, I think it was in the first period, where the door seemed to kind of be a little bit ajar. So maybe a little bit of a mechanical issue that took a moment to resolve there. A&M wins the draw to start the penalty kill and clears it all the way down. 8:15 left in this contest. NC State well in control with a 7-2 lead over A&M. Of course, on the man advantage here. Shook, the one-man break-in. Still has it in the corner. Now it finds Govea. Saucered back up top for Cox. Over to Shook. Slid back to Cox. He'll throw one on the ice in front. And it's chipped up and into the netting. We'll have another faceoff coming.
Yeah, one more thing to note about that situation in net for A&M. Because of the performance tonight from Circus in the last four periods, you may want to look to Peyton Woodley. He's only played one game today, but when you do play against UNC tomorrow on the road once again, you know, long trip, a lot of shots being faced the last two games. Over 75 shots have been faced, Circus has faced, so you may want to address that tomorrow and see what you got behind him.
Here's Holden Kaufman coming out of the scrum with it. 1:10 left on the power play for NC State. Beautiful pass across from Kaufman. Thronson couldn't deflect it on goal, though. It's loose along the side of the net. A&M comes away with it. Strong clearance there from Norwood. And NC State will reset the power play with 55 seconds to go. Thronson gains the red line, shoots it catty corner. pops straight up in the air, lands in the slot. NC State knocks it to the far side. Kaufman finds Shook with it. Now Cox along the blue line, slides it down for Thronson, who gives it back. One-timer across for Shook. Hill wrist one towards the goal, didn't get through. Govea, though, with the rebound as we're down to the last 25 seconds of the power play. Kaufman again behind the net. He'll look it over as he walks back up the circle. Into the middle for Cox. He'll swap places with Thronson and hand it off. Back to Cade Cox. Beautiful pass across for Kaufman. Looking back for Govea. That pass denied, but NC State still in control as Shook's shot is blocked. Down to 7 seconds left on the man advantage. And Texas A&M looking to clear. Beautiful glove play made by Thronson to hold his own. He'll cycle it down low. Here's Cox stepping up on the goal line, avoids a poke check. He gets hit up high, gets hit a couple extra times, still getting knocked down, and then Cox eventually wrestled to the ice. Easy call for the official as A.J. Cosman just would not let up. A lot of credit to Cox there, too. No retaliation. He just stood strong and drew the penalty.
Yeah, and I think NC State, in terms of everyone else on the ice outside of Cox, I mean, I think they could have stood up for him a little bit. There was a lot going on there that Cosman was doing, even threw an open-handed punch at him, and right in front of the net as well. Yeah, I don't know. I feel like NC State could have stood up for him a little bit, but you were right. Credit to Cade Cox there. Keeping his cool, wondering, hey, what are you doing? Maybe something was said. I'm not going to know, but the frustration boiling over for A&M. And now we got a timeout called by Texas A&M. Is the Pack are going to go back on the power play? Leave the 5-on-4 just ended for A&M. It has, so they get about a couple seconds out of it, and now they're back down a man.
Yeah, and if you're NC State at this point, you've got a 5-goal lead. Unless you make some serious errors throughout the course of this final 6-16, this game is well in hand. You'd love to score on the power play. It certainly helps the confidence and the momentum of the man advantage. But at the same time, the most important thing at this point to me is getting out of this game without getting yourself into trouble. And that means keeping your head on a swivel. We talked about that going into this period. Both teams have been throwing heavy hits, and you got to keep an eye out for that. We've seen a couple of times where guys just didn't quite have their head up, and they got their bell rung a little bit. The other part of it is you don't want to get any of your own guys in trouble with the law, so to speak, in this one, because it – you can see the frustration from A&M here. They played a pretty solid game, probably a little bit better even than they did last night. They just have not been able to keep NC State from putting it in the back of the net, so that frustration boils over a little bit. NC State starts the power play with a faceoff win. Shot from the top of the far circle from Robinson, easily handled by Circus. Turnaround pass from Herman at the blue line finds Emery Oliver. He'll shovel it back behind the goal. Getting to it there, Norwood immediately turns and clears. NC State regroups behind their own goal. Labrizzi picks it up with 1:35 on the man advantage. A roughing penalty, I believe, to A.J. Cosman. Holding the zone at the blue line was Oliver. He'll send it around the wall for Herman. Picks it up on the hashes with some time and space. Exchanges with Oliver. Great pass to find Robinson out in the high slot. His shot rose over top. NC State keeps the pressure on. Here's Arini. Feeds it through to Herman. Skate to stick and then the shot. I believe it got the shoulder of Circus before going out of play behind the net. But a well-worked power play for NC State so far. They've moved it well. They've got a couple of good shots.
Yeah, and I think the last power play as well, this is something we really haven't seen in a bit from NC State on the power play. They're able to move it right in front of the net and get a lot of good spacing, which is something we haven't really seen the past 2 days.
Labrizzi over for Robinson. Back to Nick Labrizzi. Shoots it through traffic. Emery Oliver might have gotten a piece of it with his stick, but it stays out. Herman to Labrizzi at the blue line. Again for Zach Herman. He fans on the pass, looking to the middle again. A sprawling block made there by McQuaig to keep it out of the middle. NC State holds the zone, but Oliver has it knocked away on the pass and out into neutral ice. And a misplay there will lead to a chance for A&M. Save made with the glove as Daniel Dufresne came in after the misplay. And get an offensive zone draw on the penalty kill for Texas A&M. 32 seconds left on the man advantage for NC State, 4:48 left in this hockey game.
Give credit to A&M still fighting on the penalty kill.
haven't really given up yet, which is something you always want to preach. Play the full 60 minutes, and A&M has been doing that despite the fact that NC State has been dominating offense's own time.
State controls off the draw. Cox looking to set up the breakout, finds McEnany up the far side. He'll advance it to Logan Todd. Has a trailer with a McEnany off the wall to him. Now to Cox, thrown through traffic again. That one didn't get to the net. Daniel tracks down the rebound in the near corner, sends it up the wall. A&M first to it. That should finish off the power play for NC State as Jacob Smith cleared it all the way down. 4:15 to go as we're back to 5-on-5 hockey. NC State with a 5-goal lead as Cade Cox trying to chip and chase himself. NC State will pick it up as it got stuck at the blue line. Cox again. Rink wide, taken off the boards by McEnany, who pokes it deep. First one to it, though, is Filick for the Aggies, trying to find his defensive partner there in Morrow. They are able to advance it out of the zone. Sowers trying to force his way straight through Cade Cox, and he's going to be taken down. It'll be a penalty on the NC State defenseman.
Yeah, Cox was just caught out of position, and Robbie Sowers does a fantastic job fighting for the puck to keep it going. Keep that chance alive. And Kate Cox was caught out of position a little bit in that physical battle. He went down and kind of body tripped Robbie Sowers there. And so a late power play to this game with 3:45 left for Texas A&M. A goal here would do good for a moral victory, if you will, for the Aggies against a pretty stout penalty kill, which they've scored on twice in the past 2 days.
A&M 1-for-4 on the man advantage. This is the first power play they've had since period number one. In fact, it's the first penalty called on NC State since that flurry of four in period number one. And this is really, it's a long shot for A&M to put five in the back of the net, but if they're going to, it starts with a power play goal here. Having some trouble, though, getting established. NC State clears it down once again. Already 30 seconds gone on the man advantage. Cross ice pass from Rushing to Leone. He'll walk it across the blue line. Stops near the hashes. His pass stolen away. Ooh, big hit on Bresingham. Oh. And that was unnecessary. Absolutely unnecessary from Norwood. In a 7-2 game, the puck cleared out and gone. And it was definitely a late hit.
Bresingham just back from injury too from a couple weeks ago, and so a lot of words being said right now from NC State. Ref telling the NC State bench to stay back. Jack Strong was going at it with Jacob Norwood. He's going to the box. Just, you're right, Chris. I'm not a big fan of that hit. There was really no need to take that hit. Bresingham just in a lot of pain.
Well, I think what hopefully the biggest issue here, they've got some gauze on his forehead. Mm-hmm. So that right there makes it pretty obvious that the primary point of contact was the head, as you do have Bresingham bleeding, and I mean, shoulder to the head, easy call. I think if you're Norwood, who's played a good physical game in these last two games, really, that's when you just got to let off of it. It was a second too late. There's no threat from Bresingham. He chipped it out. He was letting it go. You got to just let that one go. And it'll be interesting to see, because as it was pretty clear, it's got to be four. Got to be a double minor, because you draw blood. As soon as you do that, that's 4 minutes. The question then, as we made it's obvious principal point of contact is the head, I'd be a little bit surprised if we don't see a major here.
Yeah, I don't know. They might be taking... No matter what, the rule says any contact to the head or neck area, you're gone. It doesn't matter if you're 7'5 and you're hitting someone that's 4 feet tall. If you hit them in the head, you're out of the game. And Bresingham, a little shorter in the height department, they're going to discuss the penalty here, which was the delay. Refs were discussing the length of the penalty. They're talking to the captains about it now. But like I mentioned, Bresingham, someone who isn't as tall as Jacob Norwood is, who really a physical beast out there on the ice, but it's a play you can't make. You've got to know with that height and that body type that you have that you got to be careful with the head or neck area. Ref's still talking about it right now. The NC State bench is still pretty mad about the hit, and Norwood's Daisy, I think, is going to be done.
Yeah, he got the major, so he'll be headed off the ice.
I think we're also going to have matching minors. Kate Cox is in the penalty box for State. It looks like it'll be number 21, Kate Willis, serving the penalty for Texas A&M's Norwood, as you got to look at him heading into the locker room. I thought we were going to see an extra one because it looked like, at least from the body language of the official, the way he was kind of pointing towards both sides, I thought we were going to get matching minors in there as well. What that hit may do, too, is just completely settle this game down. Here comes rushing shot, swallowed up again by Aiden Lawrence.
And one of the keys you mentioned, CJ just got played safe. Don't get yourself in trouble with the wah. I was going to bring up, make sure you stay healthy as best as you can, and that's a play where the opposing team's going to get you hurt. And pressing it, like I mentioned before, coming back from an AC joint injury, taking a hit like that, drawing blood. You hope he's okay. I'm assuming he's going to be done for the rest of the night for health concerns, and we hope that he has a quick, speedy recovery before their home game next weekend.
Here's Jack Strong, breakout pass for Govea. He's got speed down the right wing, whistles one up over top of the net. It will ring all the way around the boards and out. Robinson in control. 25 seconds left till NC State goes on the power play. Puck gets locked up around the A&M blue line. NC State back in control. Cowan over to Strong, back across for Govea. He'll carry it in, looking to the middle for Robinson. That one floats through the slot harmlessly. Some pressure here from NC State. Now Zach Colson. He'll move it up with speed. Going to go one on two against the NC State defense. Back to five on four for NC State. It will remain that way, barring any other penalties, as Robinson and Labrizzi come in offside.
Yeah, final minute 40. I think both teams know this game is all but official. Final minute 40, maybe NC State will try to get that score differential up to 6. This is a out-of-conference game, but you always want to get that score differential up because you never know how important it may be as the season comes down.
Here's Nick Shook. Advances it into the zone. Miscommunication there with Thronson. We'll send it all the way back to Addison Lawrence. Pardon me. Labrizzi restarts. Shook cuts through the neutral zone. Has the puck knocked off his stick, but he retrieves it. Drops it off for Labrizzi. He'll walk the blue line. Slides it to Shook again. Wrist shot. Blocked down in front. McEnany couldn't get the shot away from the slot. And NC State holds the line. Labrizzi just got there in time. He'll drop it off for Shook. Rink wide for Thronson. 1 minute left in the game. Now Labrizzi holds on to it, looking for the shooting lane. It's not there. Drops it off for Thronson again. Carries it behind the goal where he leaves it for Kaufman. Swept back out to Labrizzi near side. Into the high slot. McEnany, turnaround shot, hit a skate. Ricochets back out, and Nick Shook fires it home. Well, I think if you're NC State, you know, we talk about kind of dialing it back there. I think if you're the Ice Pack, though, you want to get a goal on that power play.
Yeah, you do another power play goal for the Pack. Getting it to be 8-2. And Shook just kind of from the point gets it home. Labrizzi was calling for it a lot there. He still does not have a goal with the Ice Pack. But give credit to him. He was looking for the shot. It wasn't there, and he gave it off of his stick and gave his teammate a better shot, which then in turn allowed Shook to get the puck and get the goal. So props to Nick Labrizzi. He's still looking for that first goal, but he's a team player. He's going to find other people to get the puck if he can, and he'll rack up the assists.
NC State moves right back in, still on the power play with the major penalty. Major penalty is Cade Cox's shot deflects up and over the net.
Final 26 seconds, I'm assuming Van Empt just shoots this one down. We'll see the end of this one. But how about NC State? The struggles they saw last week, they went 0-3 up in Virginia. Were able to get two here at home against a pretty good Texas A&M team in the past. This year they are going through a lot of turnover, but getting a good win like this is always really good. Almost another chance right there from Cade Cox, but going into next week now, they've got Maryland at home, a team they, on the stat sheet, outplayed last week, lost 3-2 to the Terrapins in a game where the Terrapins only had 11 shots. I think NC State has that one circled, and they're going to be ready for that next one.
Puck advanced behind the net by NC State off the draw. Back out for Frosch. He'll throw it towards the net. Fillick deflects it to the far corner.
Swept around by Logan Todd, down under 10 seconds left. Directed out in front, Todd the shot. Oh, what a save. Circus wasn't done yet, even with 5 seconds to go, down six. He goes post to post for a big one.
Circus with a circus-like save. My goodness, able to bounce, push off with that right skate back to the glove side to snag that one away. Keep this a six-goal game.
Gonna get tied up off the draw, rushing. Just gonna take it over to the corner, and that will wind out the rest of this one. A dominant performance tonight from NC State. A little bit different than last night as they pick up an 8-2 victory.
Yeah, and I think this is the type of game NC State expected last night with the amount of success they had in the first and second period offensively, but no goals. This time, they get 4 goals in the first period, only one that second period, but 3 more the third. It's safe to say this offense has found its footing, and it'll be very interesting to see going into next week's game against Maryland, where they only put up 2 goals against them last weekend. It'll be interesting to see if this momentum for the offense keeps going as we approach the end of the semester.
So a big win, or a big sweep, really, for NC State over Texas A&M. They needed a couple of wins to get things right after a tough 3-loss weekend up at North last weekend, and a good way to bounce back. Final count here in the second of 2 games between Texas A&M and NC State. Ice Pack 8, Aggies 2. We'll be back with postgame.
From the top of D.H. Hill Library.
Don Diablo.
Oh, yeah, this is actually, like, in my studio. With
WKNC HD3 Raleigh.
Hey, what's up and what's going on, folks? This is Kid Kinetic, your boy, up here at the top of the hour. And guess what I got? A treat that's too sweet to beat.
This is Wolf Bites Radio.
Aw, that's really sweet.
NC State.
Locally owned and operated by an NC State graduate, the Red and White Shop is your source for all things NC State. Just off campus in the Ridgewood Shopping Center at 3526 Wade Avenue, the Red and White Shop has everything the NC State fan needs. Sporting goods and memorabilia, your favorite NC State team apparel, tailgating essentials, ice pack gear. A proud sponsor of the NC State hockey team, a percentage of all ice pack sales go back to the team. Stop by today or visit us online. The Red and White Shop.
Hey there, doing some yard work? Installing a new fence, flowers, or shrubs? Stop! Don't dig just yet! You have buried gas, electric, and even internet lines down there. Before you pick up a shovel, pick up a phone or go online and contact 811. 811 is a free service. Yes, free! 811 is the first step to having those buried utilities marked. 811 keeps you safe, protects the lines, and it's the law. This safety message brought to you by North Carolina 811.
At Moe's, we've always been inviting, but we have a bigger story to tell. A place that welcomes you to be you. Fresh, high-quality ingredients. We got that. Go ahead, do your thing. Come on, let's get weird. We don't judge. Moe's wants you to come in with your crew and their appetites. Dine in, pick up, or order on the Moe Rewards app. Either way, don't just stroll in. Roll all in to Moe's Southwest Grill.
I'm with 2018 lacrosse national champion Christian Gaudy for the FDA's Don't Get Burned Sunscreen Challenge.
Bring it, Daryl.
She's tough, but I won't get burned today. I'm using a broad spectrum sunscreen.
The FDA recommends broad spectrum sunscreens with an SPF of 15 or higher with other sun protection measures to reduce the risk of sunburn and skin cancer.
You smoked me, Kristen.
That's because I use sunscreen, so I wouldn't get burned by you and the sun.
Broad spectrum sunscreen. It's a winning play every time.
NC State coming away with a dominant 8-2 win over Texas A&M, sweeping the 2-game series with a 5-3 win last night. Chris Lehman, Nick Prozzi back with you post-game here on PackTV. And Nick, NC State took care of business in the third period. 3 more goals to make sure they put it away. And as we talked about, they did a good job staying disciplined,
just one penalty, I believe, in that third period. One or two penalties, but you know the way that period transpired, I thought they did a good job.
Yeah, they did. They did get a bench warning towards the end of the game, and they suffered one penalty. Excuse me right now. I had a little cough outbreak before, and we've been dealing with this, so I apologize about that. They only suffered one penalty after that onslaught of penalties that first period, and it was Cade Cox in a play. He was kind of out of position, and he kind of tripped him with his body, something, you know. It's just a hockey play. They didn't take any penalties that were necessarily bad, I think, especially as the game went on. So keep it, a team that takes a lot of penalties this year, I think they did a really good job in the second part of that game.
Well, and one of the things we highlighted coming into tonight, obviously we talked about the necessity, I guess, to stay out of the penalty box as much as they possibly could. But special teams, scoring on the power play, NC State a good job again tonight with two power play goals.
Yeah, and the penalty kill as well, only allowing one this time against Texas A&M in that initial onslaught of penalties that they experienced. So a really good job by NC State with the special teams. It was a key factor in this game.
Yeah, so NC State, big win over Texas A&M. We're going to talk with the goaltender, Addison Lawrence, when we come back.
Locally owned and operated by an NC State graduate, the Red and White Shop is your source for all things NC State. Just off campus in the Ridgewood Shopping Center at 3526 Wade Avenue, the Red and White Shop has everything the NC State fan needs. Sporting goods and memorabilia, your favorite NC State team apparel, tailgating essentials, ice pack gear. A proud sponsor of the NC State hockey team, a percentage of all ice pack sales go back to the team. Stop by today or visit us online. The Red and White Shop.
Welcome to Moe's!
At Moe's, we've always been inviting, but we have a bigger story to tell. A place that welcomes you to be you. Fresh, high-quality ingredients. We got that. Go ahead, do your thing. Come on, let's get weird. We don't judge. Moe's wants you to come in with your crew and their appetites. Dine in, pick up, or order on the Moe Rewards app. Either way, don't just stroll in. Roll all in to Moe's Southwest Grill.
It's time to talk about men's mental health.
80% of suicides are done by men.
Men are three times less likely to ask for help if they are struggling.
One man every minute
commits suicide.
Men are more likely to suffer from substance abuse disorders.
Alcohol kills six times more men than women.
Men are three times less likely to ask for help if they are struggling.
We've never needed each other more
than we do right now.
It's okay to not be okay.
It's okay to talk about how you feel.
Being silent doesn't mean you are being strong.
This is a movement for men's health.
The silence needs to be broken.
Men need support too.
The stigma.
The stigma.
The stigma.
The stigma.
The stigma.
The stigma.
The stigma ends here.
The stigma ends here.
Locally owned and operated by an NC State graduate, the Red and White Shop is your source for all things NC State. Just off campus in the Ridgewood Shopping Center at 3526 Wade Avenue, the Red and White Shop has everything the NC State fan needs. Sporting goods and memorabilia, your favorite NC State team apparel, tailgating essentials, ice pack gear. A proud sponsor of the NC State hockey team, a percentage of all ice pack sales go back to the team. Stop by today or visit us online. The Red and White Shop.
Welcome to
Moe's! At Moe's, we've always been inviting, but we have a bigger story to tell. A place that welcomes you to be you. Fresh, high-quality ingredients. We got that. Go ahead, do your thing. Come on, let's get weird. We don't judge. Moe's wants you to come in with your crew and their appetites. Dine in, pick up, or order on the Moe Rewards app. Either way, don't just stroll in. Roll all in to Moe's Southwest Grill.
Well, a big night in goal tonight for the NC State Ice Pack. I'm here with goaltender Addison Lawrence, who had a fantastic job at night tonight. Only allowed two goals, both in the first period. Going into this one, we saw a lot of rhythm issues yesterday with your teammate Isaac Toyer. He even ended up having a really good game as well. What was kind of the message going into this game, especially in that second period where you made a couple of really big saves after not seeing some shots for a while?
I mean, we kind of tightened up defense. That was a big thing in the room. We talked a lot about tightening up the defense and just keeping our foot on the pedal. Obviously, I don't know how many goals we had after the first, but it was kind of at the point where it's like, you just got to keep your head in it, act like it's a 0-0 game, and just keep moving forward.
Now, we did see you have a couple of really good saves, especially losing that rhythm, and you said you got to keep your head in it. So what are some things you kind of do when your teammates are kind of just dominating the offensive end and you're sitting back there waiting for something to happen?
I mean, most of the time it's either just watch the play and almost like talk it through, like as it's happening, like Breezy pass the puck to like Oliver or something like mm-hmm. that. Like it's almost like you just follow the play. Sometimes you announce, sometimes I do that just to keep myself in it. And then other times just kind of hang out and just try to stay focused. It's almost like a meditation in a way. Like you're just there mm-hmm. not doing anything and you just have to try to stay, like not have any thoughts come in that are just out of whack. So
gotta stay on your toes. And then one final question for you tonight, another good night in net for you. Going into this one, what were your kind of thoughts going into this after last weekend had another great performance? And your stat sheet, the wins and losses haven't added up, but the stats are certainly there to show you need a lot more wins. Going into this one, what was your kind of thought of keeping that hot streak going in net?
I mean, so I'll be honest, I don't even know what my stats are. I don't look at my stats. I don't want to know them. But, I mean, kind of like the same thing I said last time when we had this conversation. It was like just show up to the rink. Every game's different. You don't know what's going to happen. You just have to be ready. So prepare the same way and just keep moving along.
Well, I can tell you your goals against average went down tonight just a little bit. It was at around 2.9 before. So another solid night for you. When we come back, we'll have head coach of the Ice Pack, Tim Healy, here on PackTV.
Locally owned and operated by an NC State graduate, the Red and White Shop is your source for all things NC State. Just off campus in the Ridgewood Shopping Center at 3526 Wade Avenue, the Red and White Shop has everything the NC State fan needs. Sporting goods and memorabilia, your favorite NC State team apparel, tailgating essentials, ice pack gear. A proud sponsor of the NC State hockey team, a percentage of all ice pack sales go back to the team. Stop by today or visit us online. The Red and White Shop.
From the top of DH Hill Library.
Don Diablo.
Oh, yeah, this is actually like in my studio. With
WKNC HD3 Raleigh.
Hey, what's up and what's going on, folks? This is Kid Kinetic, your boy, up here at the top of the hour. And guess what I got? A treat that's too sweet to beat.
This is Wolf Bites Radio.
Aw, that's really sweet.
NC State.
We've always been inviting, but we have a bigger story to tell. A place that welcomes you to be you. Fresh, high-quality ingredients. We got that. Go ahead, do your thing. Come on, let's get weird. We don't judge. Moe's wants you to come in with your crew and their appetites. Dine in, pick up, or order on the Moe Rewards app. Either way, don't just stroll in. Roll all in to Moe's Southwest Grill.
We're back with head coach Tim Healy of the NC State Ice Pack as NC State comes away with an 8-2 win and a two-game sweep in the series against Texas A&M. Coach, obviously it took a little while to get going last night, but the offense really got going and you picked up right where you left off. How does it feel?
It feels great. You know, we haven't had many back-to-backs this year and, you know, continue to be tough on home ice. Mm-hmm. And, you know, you talk about the 8 goals and continuing. Yep. And that was actually the message before the game was think of, you know, the third period last night as if we're just going into a next period here, carry that momentum, used to seeing pucks going in the net. And, you know, that was the message tonight and 4 goals in the first period. So we are feast or famine on the score sheet, I'll tell you that much.
Well, one thing we've talked about over the course of the broadcast tonight and kind of over the course of the season is your bounce back ability, the resiliency for this team. And you do fall behind an early goal, but you're able to come back from it. How nice is it to have this team that can shake off a goal like that and come right back?
You know, we're putting a lot of new pieces together, right? Yep. Ultimately, and let's have these growing pains now. We've had those years where you know, for example, was it 3 years ago, the year after North Dakota Nationals, we were at one point, we were ranked number one in the region, and we kind of, you know, we kind of died off at the end. So, you know, hopefully this is the start of us going forward. You know, the first set of rankings came out, and, you know, it matters where you are in February, but we actually have the number one strength of schedule. So hopefully that notion of going through all that early on, you know, iron sharpens iron, right?
Yep. The other thing that you've done well over the last couple of games in particular is the power play. You've got a couple of goals on the man advantage in both games, plus a shorthanded in there. How much has your special teams really played into? I know you spend a lot of time working on that in practice.
We do, and you know, obviously we don't want to have a weekend like we had last weekend where we're not scoring a lot. Mm-hmm. But it was just irrefutable that we had to change up and put where some different guys are, right? Sometimes it's when you're in between, it's like, oh, do I make a little tweak? We're almost there. But it was so obvious we had to make. And I wanted to say, you know, they weren't so drastic in the sense of different guys on, but really shuffling the deck of, you know, which guy in the point is working with which guys. And, you know, certainly it worked out this weekend.
Well, and that was something you talked about with me a little bit before the game yesterday as you were shuffling around some lines a little bit. One of the lines you were really interested in seeing was that Kaufman and Govea line out there as well with Nick Shook, which looked really good, generated a lot of chances. The line I think that impressed me the most, though, was that line centered by Zach Herman with Aiden Brenner out there and Garrett Arini. Obviously, you've got your captain out there, but to have that as that third line on the depth chart certainly is maybe a little bit of a luxury, if we can call it that.
Well, and I don't, you know, and tonight I think we actually played the Oliver line as three. But yeah, that line tonight was great. And they're hard to play against, right? And not just in terms of, they're hard to play against in speed. They're smart. They can finish. And with that speed too, right? You saw G's goal,
yep.
Right? Where it kind of came out of nowhere, right? That speed is there, boom, they're gone. You know, you talk about the, what was it, you know, the old Miami Hurricanes teams where they got out running with it, if they're even or leaving, and that's kind of what they are. And Brenner does a really good job of, you know, finding, almost quarterbacking it, right? Is it Garrett that's shrieking? Is it Herman that's shrieking? So, you know, and making that, and that was a great pass that he made there too to G on his goal to open up the third.
Oh, yeah. And again, with 5-plus goals for NC State, you get free queso at the Village District Moe's tomorrow. Head in, tell them queso goal, and you'll get your free queso. Chris Lehman with head coach Tim Healy of the Ice Pack after an 8-2 win over Texas A&M. One last question for you, Coach. As you go into next weekend, you've got Maryland, a team that you lost to last weekend. And obviously, you feel like you didn't have the offense, so playing at home, I think things will be a little bit different. But what did you learn from that game?
I think we... Well, A, you know, it's part of it is what made us do some of the shuffling for the combination. So, you know, we're not even playing in the same lines that we were in that game. And B, that we have to go to the tougher, dirtier places for goals, right? Like, their goalie's good, and if he sees it, he's going to stop it. So that's the other takeaway from that. And I think they'll just be hungry for some payback after it.
Oh, yeah. Well, congratulations on the win, Coach.
Thanks, Chris.
Next weekend should be a good one as well. Right. NC State winners for the second night in a row over Texas A&M. Final count. 8-2. We'll see you next weekend.